Tonight from the Carrier Dome in Syracuse, Super Sports presents NCAA Lacrosse, the Blue Jays of Johns Hopkins, and the Orange Men of Syracuse. It is the second time in Johns Hopkins history they are playing an indoor lacrosse game. The first time was in the Astrodome back in 1971 when they met Navy. Hi again, everybody. This is Dave Cohen along with Dale Drypulcher, and welcome to another season of Syracuse University Lacrosse. You know, Dale, in the opening game of any season in any sport, there's always great optimism, but there are also a number of unanswered questions. And even though Syracuse and Hopkins are among the elite in college lacrosse, they're both wondering, I think, a little bit about their close defense.
Well, you know, even though, as you said, they are the elite of lacrosse in the country, they do lose people to graduation, and that's one of the problems. Both teams have some people back, but they are inexperienced at the close-in defense. They've retreaded some people. They've got some young people, some sophomores, and this is a tough game to have your close defense say, okay, go on out and get some experience against Hopkins, and Hopkins got to say, yeah, sure, go on out and get some experience against Syracuse. So I think the close-in defenses are really going to have their hands full, and it's going to be birth under fire for those guys today.
Gone from Hopkins are four of their five defensive starters, including three-time All-American John D. Tomasi. Also, from Syracuse's standpoint, Kevin Sheehan, Jeff Desko have graduated. So let's talk a little about some of the firepower on the part of both teams. And for Hopkins, we begin with Craig Bubier.
Well, Craig Bubier is a real problem for Syracuse because of his size. He's 6'3", 210 pounds. And talking to the Syracuse coaches, they said that that is a problem. Their defensemen are not that big, and he's a real muscle man. He can really push them around in there.
And Hopkins certainly has more firepower besides Bubier. They've got Brian Wood, who's playing in a new spot this year.
Well, Brian Wood was an attack man last year, and they figured they needed a little bit of help. They moved him out to the midfield. And when you've got an athlete like Wood, it really isn't much of a transition. I'm sure he'll pick it up. But he's going to do what's best for the team. He's going to move off the attack side, move into the midfield. And I think it's going to help Hopkins. Obviously, they feel they made the change, and that's what they're looking for, a little bit of scoring out of both of those guys, one from attack, one from midfield.
And Brian Wood and the rest of the Blue Jays will be shooting at Syracuse goalie Jim Guirie. Guirie and Wood, former high school rivals down in Annapolis.
Well, Jim Guirie is out of the Annapolis area, and he has done a good job for Syracuse. He's got over a 60% save ratio, which is excellent. Some people felt he had a slump last year in the middle, but I think he's back. He feels very confident, and if he's going to get off to a good season, this is a real confidence builder. If he has a good game against Hopkins, everything else should be easy, right?
Each team has a World Cup player, and for Syracuse, it was Todd Curry out of West Genesee.
Well, Curry had 47 points last year for the Orange Men, and number 16, it seems he's been a fixture around here for years, and he definitely is a man to look for offensively. Syracuse doing a little bit, some different things offensively. We'll try to pick that up when the game goes on, Dave.
Syracuse absolutely shocked Hopkins in the opening game last year down at Homewood Field, jumping to a 9-1 lead and then clinging to an 11-10 victory. We'll see how things turn out in the opening game this year when we return right after this. And here's a look at the starting lineups. First for Hopkins, left to right, the attack of Craig Bubier, a senior, 35 goals, 7 assists. Mike Morrill, a junior, 24-8. And John Ciccaroni, a sophomore, who did not play last season. The attack for Johns Hopkins University. Now the midfield, Brian Wood, the senior, the World Cup participant, 22 goals, 28 assists. He's out of Annapolis. Bruce Chanichug, who wears number 13, 3 goals and 7 assists a year ago. And sophomore Brendan Kelly, 9 goals and 11 assists. The defense for Johns Hopkins, Dave Pietramala, Greg Lilly, and James D. Tomasso, younger brother of the now graduated John D. Tomasso. And the goalie, Stuart Jones, he is a senior. Hopkins is coached by Don Zimmerman. Now the Syracuse attack, senior Gordy Mapes, 33 goals, 31 assists. Senior Tom Nelson, 29 goals, 32 assists. Younger brother of the record setter, Tim Nelson. Sophomore John Zilberti, 33 goals, 41 assists. The Syracuse midfield, three seniors there as well. Rhett Cavanaugh, 10-6 a year ago. Todd Curry, the World Cup representative from Syracuse, 35 goals, 12 assists. Pat Donahue, 11 goals and 4 assists. And on defense for the Orange Men, Mike O'Donnell, he is a senior. Dan Pratt is a senior. And a newcomer to this year's starting close defense, James McNamara, out of West Genesee High School. The goalie from Annapolis, Maryland, fifth-year senior, Jim Guirie, stopped 64% of his shots a year ago. Syracuse and Johns Hopkins getting set to meet for the 17th time. In the previous 16 meetings, Johns Hopkins has won 12, Syracuse has won 3, one game ended in a tie. Back in 1983, Syracuse came from behind to defeat Johns Hopkins down at Rutgers to win the NCAA championship, and then Hopkins turned the tables the next 2 years in 84 and 85, winning the championships. A year ago, neither team made it to the final round, and that was the first year of the Final Four format. A look at the Syracuse head coach, Roy Simmons, took over for his father, the coach emeritus. And Don Zimmerman, of course, the head coach for Johns Hopkins. One of the biggest crowds ever for a lacrosse-only affair here in the Dome. There have been some big crowds when Syracuse has had a lacrosse game preceded by a spring football scrimmage. Greg Gunning out to take the face-off against Pat Donahue for Syracuse. We'll set the teams for you as we get underway. Gunning and Donahue. Greg Gunning, a sophomore. And here we go. Chased down by Rhett Cavanaugh, number 13, Syracuse's speediest player. And Hopkins will settle back on defense. Rhett Cavanaugh being watched by Brian Wood, now playing in the midfield. And Cavanaugh immediately goes behind the cage. Trying to beat Wood to his spot. He's in close. Score! 22 seconds in, Rhett Cavanaugh shakes free of Brian Wood, and Syracuse jumps to a 1-0 lead.
Well, off to a quick jump, Syracuse. Rhett Cavanaugh, the transfer from Army, he goes down to the right. Watch what happens. Wood goes down. He's got a free shot at the goalie. And, of course, not much he can do about it. Unassisted goal.
So Syracuse out to the 1-0 lead. And you wonder, Dale, based upon the way that Wood was unable to stop, whether the turf is a little bit new in terms of footing for Johns Hopkins.
Defensively, they are all over.
A pass back to the goalie, nearly into the cage. And now Hopkins gets it up to Wood as they come across for the first time. Matched up with Gordy Mapes, Brian Wood. Changing direction, and he scores, beating Jim Guiry. So a pair of Annapolis players right there. Wood beats Guiry, and this game is only 47 seconds old, and each team has scored.
Wood gets a jump, and he just got down there on the fast break. Transition game, and Jim Guiry is thinking right now, boy, I'd like some help. I hope somebody can get on that stick, and they don't. And he beats Guiry on the offside. Guiry not able to get that stick over, tried to come up with a handle of the stick. Wasn't able to do it one-on-one. It's one apiece with, as you said, 47 seconds left. 47 seconds gone, I should say, in the first period.
Well, Syracuse has controlled both face-offs, and a near disaster in front of the Hopkins cage ends up becoming the tying score of the game. Gunning taking the face-off and now redirecting it back to his goalie. And Syracuse's Tom Nelson will apply pressure. Here comes Jones way out of the cage. Throwing to the near sideline and over the stick of the intended receiver, if you will.
Brendan Kelly was down, had the stick up, ball went over his head, and Syracuse will get the turnover.
Kelly injured early on in the preseason practice. There was some doubt as to whether he would be available for the first home game, let alone the first game of the year. But he's in there, obviously, and operating well. Syracuse redirecting to Guiry. Going to be chased a little bit by Mike Morrill. Up ahead he goes to O'Donnell, and the big stick will send it back.
Now McNamara's got the ball now. He's only a sophomore. He gets it back up to O'Donnell. This is the pressure it puts on a defense.
Mishandle.
Not only do you have to play defense, but you have to be able to handle the ball in the clear. Syracuse gives up a ground ball. Haven't lost it yet, but I think it's going to be off a Syracuse stick, and that will give Hopkins the ball in the Syracuse end of the field. But as I was saying, Dave, it's not enough just to be able to play defense. You've got to be able to clear the ball, and Syracuse defense, a little problem handling at that time, but Hopkins will get an opportunity.
Jim McNamara
is going to have the ball.
Jim McNamara was unable to control it in the corner for Syracuse. Here's Bubier going way outside. Now it's in the stick of Larry Ledoyen. Ledoyen beating Burt, and the shot is saved by Guiry. He gets it out, intended for Scaramuzzino in the big stick midfield. And he has it knocked out of his stick by John Dressel.
John Dressel really hustled. Scaramuzzino had the long stick. Dressel took it right away from him, knocked the ball down. Syracuse loses possession, and Dressel will handle it to start.
John Dressel, a junior, out of Lawrenceville. And here he is, Dressel.
Hopkins, a lot of movement. Nobody behind the cage. All the attack men are out, and they're just popped somebody off the crease.
Moving now, the ball is Bubier. Delayed flag. Everybody comes out of the net.
That'd be a hold.
And Don Zimmerman sends in his man-up team.
First man-up opportunity of the game. We watch the hold as Bubier, we talked about his size, 6'3", 210, makes the move. And as he goes inside, not able to be handled by Dan Pratt, and he had to hold him. 30 seconds. Hopkins, man up.
Well, if you're going to foul, at least the opposition doesn't get the shot away. Wood is out at the point, number 15. Hopkins working it around. Now Ladoya, number 14. Back he goes to Wood. 17 there is John Wilkins. And again, it's Wood. Wood rifles it down close and beyond the grasp of number 21, Jeff Iam, in on the man-up attack.
They worked the ball very well, back and forth, and then when Iam popped out, they couldn't make the pass too high. Let's not forget, this is the first game for both teams. We're liable to see a little bit of that kind of passing, and as the season goes on, that will sharpen up. Right now, Syracuse has got to be able to clear the ball.
Todd Curry dodging by Steve Mitchell, honorable mention All-America a year ago. Curry has some great legs under him as he goes by another Hopkins player into the attacking area. And now he'll set it up, he'll back it out.
That should, if released, I don't know how much time was left on the penalty, but he just ran it down, got it in the box.
Chris Burt departs, Dan Pratt comes on, so does Pat Donahue. Now it's Donahue with the ball. Faking left and right, still has it. Ladoyan gives him a little bit of room, look back toward the cage. And Donahue, the senior from West Genesee. So many of the Syracuse players out of that high school right in the Syracuse area. Brett Cavanaugh got the first goal. And John Zilberti is going to be closest to it. In fact, he gets it before it goes out of bounds. Zilberti dealing outside, mishandle. Scoop back to Cavanaugh. Now Zilberti. Way out and over the head and out to midfield. The battle is on. Looks like Bubier has dug it out.
Back down, ground ball.
Bubier tries for it again. Instead, it's taken away by Morrill.
Fast break. He's got a man open on the wing.
Morrill, a junior out of St. Paul. Shot. Guyrie saves. And he outlets it quickly. Upfield to Curry. Hopkins getting back nicely on defense.
Mitchell getting back. Number 44 for... And the flag is going to be down. So I think Hopkins offside. Syracuse will have an opportunity here to get a free shot off. Curry moving one-on-one against Mitchell. Takes a left-handed shot. Oh!
Curry used a whole host of players, white and blue shirts, to screen the goalie. As he came off that screen, he fired, and the delayed penalty
should be wiped out by the goal, I believe. If it was offsides, I'm sure that's what it was. But watch, Stuart Jones, the goalie, gets beat stick side, but as you said, he really couldn't see the ball to the last minute. It wasn't especially hard shot, but well disguised.
He shot that in a crowd.
Yes, he did.
And so the shooting has been excellent so far. Syracuse has taken two shots, and they've both beaten Stuart Jones. It's a 2-1 Syracuse lead. Games here in the Carrier Dome tend to be very high scoring. Bill Dirgel digs it out. Third faceoff he has won, and he's going to stay on, making a move toward the cage. Dirgel, a faceoff specialist.
Well, they felt that they had to get a little more out of him. They just can't. He's going to have to be able to deal with the ball. He just can't do the faceoffs, and right now he's doing it.
See, and he's coming in for a shot. He scores, beats the goalie high.
Oh, boy.
And a marker is down as well. There's a happy man.
That should be wiped out, but as we said last year, he pretty much just faced off, but he takes a left-handed shot, and he beats Jones up high. And just as I said, they expect a little more out of him. He takes that left-handed shot on the way down after a push, or just before the push, and he comes up with a big goal.
He only had two goals all last year, and now Bill Dirgel makes it a 3-1 Syracuse lead. On the face again, it'll be Dirgel and Greg Gunning. Dirgel is a junior out of Rochester. And Gunning, as we told you, a sophomore.
Ball
Dirgel down on the ground, tried to dig it out, and he's still trying, but Gunning is closest to it. And now Hopkins gets control. Brian Wood.
unsettled for a second. Wood's going to settle them down and get into their offense as they get their face-off people out and bring on Chanachuk. And number 32, Brendan Kelly.
Brendan Kelly, as you'll see momentarily, favoring the high-top sneakers. Here's Brian Wood, one-on-one. They won't give him the right-handed shot, not yet. Gary played it perfectly. The rebound, though, to Hopkins. That's Gary's third save of the game. Syracuse leads it 3-1. 9.5 minutes to go in this first quarter. John Ciccarone, number four. And here's Brendan Kelly. Outside he goes now. Bruce Chanachuk, number 13. Leaving it again for Kelly.
Scaramuzzino for Syracuse. Big stick. And they're doing a lot of cutting. Nobody behind the crease. A
couple of small men, and Scaramuzzino goes over the top to bring them down. Syracuse mishandling it, trying to come out of there. Bubier got it, and now Kelly. And he'll send it cross field, nearly intercepted. Open cage, and the shot is missed by Chanachuk. He had Gary flat on his face, 5 feet out of the cage, and Chanachuk missed it all.
Syracuse having a little trouble settling down, leaving people open on the unsettled situation. Chanachuk snuck down by the wing. They got the ball over to him, and as you said, he had them all beat, couldn't put it in the hole.
Hopkins, though, will retain possession. John Ciccarone, son of the former Hopkins coach, making a move against McNamara, going outside to Morrill. And still Wood now misplaying it at midfield. And somebody stepped over the line. It's offsides against Dave Pietramala.
Part of the Carrier Dome crowd enjoying this contest so far. 8:42 left first period, 3-1 Syracuse. And that step on the midfield line will cost possession to Hopkins, and Syracuse gets an opportunity.
Todd Curry has it. Curry has one of the three Syracuse goals.
And one of the things you talked about before is his speed, Dave, and when he cleared the ball before and brought him back to from man down to even, shows you exactly what he can do. He's got great speed.
So far, many of the Hopkins fans who've made the trip up to Syracuse have been rather quiet. They've got a little bit of a pep band here as well.
Yeah, quite a few people from Hopkins.
Tom Nelson is the younger brother, the all-time leading scorer in college lacrosse, Tim Nelson. This is John Zilberti.
They've got a set play now that they called out. Syracuse called out Maryland.
Now Todd Curry. My memory is correct. Zilberti has changed his number.
Yes, I think he did.
Eric Jeschke, I think, wore number 11 a year ago.
That's right. He hasn't changed his hairstyle, though.
Here's Curry again going left. Let's see if he shoots it again. He does, and he scores. Virtually the same move he made earlier, that hard shot coming off the screen. And he's beaten Stuart Jones again.
He dealt there. He went left by DiTomaso and Mitchell, and nobody could get a stick on him. Watch him. Again, not a real hard shot, but Hopkins is going to take a timeout. And you see the aftermath. And Syracuse now 4-1, and we'll be back right after this.
Syracuse out to a 4-1 lead on Johns Hopkins. Every goal so far in the game, all five of them have been unassisted. We'll get another look at that goal by Todd Curry, his second of the game, and here it is.
Here comes Curry. The speed that we talked about, again, not a hard shot, and Mitchell, 44, was closest to him, and you could see he was not pleased that he could not get his stick on Curry's stick, and Curry zipped it by Stuart Jones.
And that time he was really not screened, the goalie, Stuart Jones. Pat Donahue and Greg Gunning. Gunning has the face, trying to get it upfield. Stolen away from behind by Burke, picked up by Mapes. And in the middle, it's Kavanaugh going before he actually had the ball. He's going to draw some attention from Brian Wood. Splits the defense there. On the wing, it's a hard shot on the way. Saved nicely by Stuart Jones. And he says somebody stepped in his territory there in the crease.
Big cylinder up there. You can't reach through and touch his stick, and that's exactly what happened. So they'll get a free clear. There was no possession, but they will get a free clear at midfield.
And that is the first save, I believe, for Stuart Jones.
It was a good one.
Now Brendan Kelly back out to Brian Wood. By the way, at halftime, you'll meet Brian Wood as well as Todd Curry, two World Cup players on the United States team this past summer.
You can't really see in the picture. When you see that, look at the crease. Look at all the guys from Hopkins. There's nobody behind. They got somebody up by the crease. close, and then they got three other people standing right along the crease. Really gets crowded in there. Now they spread it out a little bit.
Bubier is on the side of the crease, the left side, as the crease comes into your picture. Wood now going to Brendan Kelly, working one-on-one and being taken down. It's kicked ahead to Burt, and we're going to get a holding call.
That'll cost Syracuse 30, so they will be manned down for another 30-second penalty.
Chris Burt there with the bandage on his right leg took a hard shot in the shin area in the practice last night.
One of the things Hopkins was doing, at least on that offensive series, is they were popping people out of the crease, hoping to get a shot down, and they got a hold of Syracuse all over Kelly.
Second man up opportunity of the game for Hopkins. Syracuse successfully killed off the first opportunity, got the ball down into the box and had the man released. Ladoya, number 14, now Morrill and Bubier, and Wood is out there. Ooh. Here's his shot, goes wide, but Bubier is there to keep it in Blue Jay way.
Boy, he took a blister city there. Guyrie went down, Pratt went in the goal too, but ball not on target.
6:20 to go in this first period. Syracuse leading it 4-1.
Evened up right now.
Ladoyan sending it to Bubier. And now it's Brian Wood. Attack man turned midfielder. Moving on, Chris Burt. Gives it up. Very deliberate attack by Johns Hopkins.
Yep, they had three people in the crease. Now they're going to move people back up away from the crease and look for cutters.
Jeff Heim trying to go one-on-one. They push him. He shoots, and it's Guyrie down for the save out of the cage. And Iam is in there.
Oh, boy.
Gets shoved right through the crease. He paid the price.
They're going to say no possession push, I believe. Yes. I like that. The officials both looked at each other to make sure they had the same call. It gets very confusing there. But, indeed, it was a push on Syracuse. Watch what happens. There's the move. There's the shot by Iam. The ball's down. Now he's got Guyrie out. Now here it comes. There it is. Boom. From behind.
Looked to me like Guyrie made that save with a face mask.
Well, anything counts. Face mask. Give you good help on occasion when you're in that 36 square feet.
Now Bubier starting outside, trying to work for position.
Oh, doubled.
A lot of one-on-one play. Now he whips it across. They go to the other side of the cage. And Guyrie down for
good
the save,
save
on Morrill. The race for the ball, and it's going to be Syracuse's.
We talked about Bubier's size, and that was a very, very strong shot. As they got it across, Bubier down to Morrill, but it just was low, and he came out with the feet and did a great job of that ball. Must have gone 20 feet in the air after it deflected off his feet or stick. I couldn't see what he got it with.
You see the goalie now, Guyrie, giving that windup sign. What is he doing?
Well, he's trying to get the people to move. In other words, okay, midfielders, we're going to set the clear up. Now you move when I move my arm, and now they're going to bring it up the side, and they're going to redirect. Syracuse very deliberate now with their clear. And O'Donnell was kind of by himself on this wing, and he got it off to Curry, and Curry knows what to do.
Except he nearly threw it over the head of the man over there.
Offside.
The big stick, yep. Dan Pratt, and Syracuse is offside.
Curry was offside. Now, these are the early season fouls that happen because your timing's not quite down yet. You've really only played your own team. Syracuse did get a scrimmage against Cornell, which is kind of unusual since they're going to play them during the year, but the timing isn't quite there yet, and Curry clearly offside. Syracuse giving another opportunity to Johns Hopkins.
Larry Ladoyan is number 14. He'll trigger it in. Redirecting to his goalie, Jones, up the sideline now. He's got Pietramala coming in. Shoots and he scores. Barry had a clear shot at stopping that, and he just simply could not.
Pietramala was left all by himself along the side. He came down with that big defensive stick, took the left-handed shot. There he is. Nobody close to him, can't even harass him, and he was only about 10 yards out when he took the shot, and really difficult for Guyrie to do much. You get another angle here, and you see this from behind, and you see the great shot, and he beat Guyrie low, looks like between his legs, and Pietramala happy Hopkins as he brings Hopkins up to 4-2 now. 4:34 left in the first quarter.
Out to take the face, Pat Donahue, and once again, Greg Gunning. It's a 4-2 Syracuse game, so we won't have any 9-1 start this year.
Well, they had
Mitchell digs it out.
He's a big kid, too, and he really just muscled his way past
the Syracuse wing middies on that. And you look at Mitchell. We talked about DiTommaso being, or excuse me, we talked about the big defenseman. They've got Mitchell at 6'5", 210, Dave, and Bubier is 6'3", 210. So there's two good-sized guys.
Todd Curry's got the ball in his stick. Rhett Kavanaugh is number 13. Now Kavanaugh cuts through, and Curry, who scored twice going to his left, is heading right.
They had a 2-2-2 set up. Two men out, two on the crease, and two behind, but now it looks like Kavanaugh's by himself with Mitchell, 44.
Curry against Mitchell, spinning, trying to work his way free. Ooh. For the hard shot.
He went high. You see, he was dealing with Mitchell back and forth, and each step he gained a little bit. Mitchell at 6'5", got a lot of power, but Curry a little bit more in the foot speed.
Tom Nelson been rather quiet so far. He's crafty in this position on the field. Good save by Jones. It's out of the crease, and the bodies are flying, and Nelson just ran over number 37, Greg Lilly of Hopkins. And so on the violations, Hopkins will get it back, trailing 4-2.
Hey, Hopkins bench wanted a cross check on that. All they got was a push, so they'll have the ball behind, attempt to clear. LeDoyen will pick it up as they get their people in the game. LeDoyen back with the ball. Gives it to goalie.
And now Pietramala got that last goal, number 43. Syracuse going to apply a ride now. LeDoyen on the far side. He's got Chanichuk in the middle of the field. But instead,
Russell has the ball, but
Pat
he's going to get doubled.
Sandwiched and taken away. And now regained by Hopkins.
Chanichuk did a great job of getting the stick up, starts the fast break.
They got a 5-on-2 if they hustle, but Syracuse comes away with it. And a whistle will stop play. A push against Syracuse.
Syracuse has had some problems with some penalties, and you can only give Hopkins so many opportunities, it seems, and they got detected pushing. But Chanichuk started this all off by stopping, intercepting the pass, knocking it down, and going downfield. I don't pick up the push, but the official saw that's all that counts.
Called it against Dan Pratt, 36. Hopkins trying to get into their set offense now. Russell is on. Russell Lamoro works in, and he scores. Well, we're seeing the new Syracuse defense being tested in close. Sheehan and Desco have graduated, and so far it's been a stiff test for Dan Pratt and as well as Mike O'Donnell in close.
Well, Batweeney, 22, is the big stick midfielder. And right there, it's all over. He's got to get help, and actually it was O'Donnell. The Dweeney slid over to help him, but O'Donnell, 31, right there, gives him the angle, and Morrill just takes a high bouncer past Guyery. So the help didn't get there in time. The slide wasn't there on time. 4-3 now.
And still lots of time to go, even in this first quarter, 2:51.
This is the Blue Jay bench, Coach Zimmerman.
Bill Durgo for Syracuse wins the face on his back. He gives it up, however. Here's Brian Wood. Hopkins looking to tie it now. Wood is jostled and dropped.
Kavanaugh did that. Durgo may pick it up on the side.
And Syracuse is going to be offsides.
Now timeout. Ooh.
Brian Wood is down.
That's the call. That was not offside. I thought that might be it. They were close to it, but number 15 is down, and they stopped the game immediately.
Brian Wood is down. It appears to be his left leg.
You can see right there, they're looking at the left ankle. And the officials, you know, if they don't think it's a serious injury, they may let the game continue, but there was no doubt about it. When Wood went down, they stopped it immediately, and they are looking at that left ankle. And Brian Wood is a key player on this Hopkins team. Obviously, we talked to him. We talked about him at the top of the show. See if we can pick up what happened here. There's Wood on Kavanaugh. Plants. Ooh, looks like right there. Yeah, the way he picked it up, I'm sure he twisted that ankle underneath him, and Yep, you can tell right there. Kavanaugh was defending him, and he put that left foot down. It looks like he just hit it on the turf, and boy, he twisted it underneath him.
They collided initially, and then it was that left foot that turned over. And Brian Wood, let's see, from the way he's walking it off, if they get it taped up and keep the swelling down, he may be back sooner than we think.
Ice and tape. Ice and tape, and being the competitor that he is, I'm sure he'll be back. He's walking real well.
The nature of this sport, too, is that you want to play the best at their healthiest.
Yeah. Well, we'll see what the call. I believe Syracuse had the ball when play was stopped.
And now they mark it for play again. We resume with 2.5 minutes to go in the first quarter. Rhett Kavanaugh, who opened up the scoring for Syracuse, has it. He's number 13. And he's being played, guarded by Mike Webster.
Webster, a senior, 5'11", 175.
Kavanaugh down, still had control, put it on the ground, intended for Tom Nelson, taken away by Pietramala. And now it is Webster.
Fast break. Webster going to let him set up. He gets the ball off to
Ciccarone. Ciccarone has it now. John Ciccarone. Now Mike Morrill. He's got a goal. Ledoyen comes into the picture, number 14. Bubier still camped out.
Russell got a jump coming out of the penalty or the substitution area, but Syracuse picked him up.
Morrill operating
inside
again where he did earlier. And the stop made by Geyer, who's out of the cage, is fair.
That's
game.
That's a push.
But that is illegal.
Yep. Well, Morrill went on O'Donnell again, as you said. Didn't work that time, but he thought he might go back to it. The save up with the ground ball by Geyer, then he got pushed. So Syracuse will have the ball behind. There's the move right there. He gets some help late, but Morrill has been moving very, very well on the cage, and there's, you'll see the push right there.
More of a persistence than a shove.
Well, I'll tell you, Hopkins is playing tenacious defense, and they're really going after ground balls. When it's down, they're going after it. So Syracuse, both teams playing with a great intensity.
Syracuse has Greg Burns on for the first time, number 14. He's a freshman out of Jamesville DeWitt, and there's his first college goal. So Greg Burns has re-upped the lead for Syracuse to 2 goals. They now lead it 5-3.
Burns took that left-handed shot and all by himself out there with the strong wrists, because nobody there, just one hopper right on the far side.
14, Greg Burns.
And you see it again,
16, Todd,
as Stuart Jones, not able to get the stick
Burns
on it, makes it 5-3 with 1:22 left, Dave.
And we have our first assisted goal of the game as Todd Curry picks up the assist to go along with his 2 goals. Bill Dirgel on the faceoff, still working hard. Lost there by Steve Mitchell, who's again in pursuit. Who's got it? Hopkins does.
Yeah, it was off one of the Syracuse players. Mitchell, good hustle, 44. Syracuse has been able to control the faceoff, the initial draw, but Hopkins, as we said, really contesting every ground ball, and that bounced off a Syracuse player.
Bruce Chanichuk on the sideline has the ball in his stick. He gets the whistle, and we begin play. Large crowd on hand here at the Carrier Dome as we come to you live on Home Team Sports.
Syracuse hoping to get a turnover here as they force the long pass with a defensive stick. Nice move.
And they go to Lilly. Lilly in the middle of the field now to Wilkins, looking for a man to dish it off to. He's going to go. Still in control. Now he overshoots his man, heading toward the penalty box and out of bounds.
Hopkins cleared the ball very, very well. Greg Lilly, the sophomore, one of the defensemen that's going to get a lot of playing time in that close-in defense that we have talked about, as Stuart Jones has in front of him, and I can't say that they have been at fault all the time. Jones has had a couple of opportunities one-on-one, but it's tough. But as they said, this is a young defense, but they are hustling.
Now for the first time, Syracuse has sent on one of their Canadian twins, number 38, Gary Gait, out of Brentwood Bay, British Columbia. Number 38. Now we get a whistle. This some discussion as to where the ball should be put in play. Also on for the first time, Earl Hall for Syracuse. And it's a timeout for an equipment repair as somebody's tying their shoes.
Coach Simmons, junior. Son is down at Cuca College coaching. Was an assistant here last year. Tim Nelson, one of the assistant coaches.
In fact, now we have both the Gait brothers, identical twins, Gary and Paul Gait. This is Todd Curry. Getting up ahead of steam, throwing it back to the middle to one of the Gait brothers. Save, and a flag is down.
Slash. So number 43 detected. Pietramala on the slash. That'll send him out for a minute.
Paul Gait leads the field, number 39.
Now, British Columbia, that's a long way away from here. That's north of California. There's Curry, and he drops the ball back to number 38. And Gait not able
Hopkins
to put it in, but both freshmen getting some playing time early in the season.
Is this the first man-up opportunity for Syracuse?
I believe it is. Maybe the second. Second man-up opportunity for Syracuse. Had a little trouble controlling the ball. Syracuse going to be patient.
Chris Rossi is on, number 21. Looking back toward the bench for some instructions as they try to get this man-up play underway. Todd Curry, real cat-and-mouse game.
Well, Zilberti's behind.
And now Curry, they're all over him. I think he was waiting for the period to end.
Yep.
And so we've come to the end of the first quarter with a score, Syracuse 5, Johns Hopkins 3. Back here in the Carrier Dome in Syracuse as we come to you live on Home Team Sports, Dave Cohen, Dale Dreipulcher. And Dale, for our viewers, you might explain why Syracuse just stalled out the last few seconds of that first quarter.
Well, it should negate the faceoff. If there's a man down situation, the team in possession with the ball at the end of that quarter will get the ball, and that's what Syracuse tried to do. There's the first quarter stats. Shots 12 and 9. Hopkins got the 12. Saves, you can see they got some shots on goal. Guyrie did a pretty good job. Ground balls, both teams hustling. Syracuse was 16. Man-up goals, one out of two for Syracuse, zero for two for Hopkins. Face-offs, pretty even, 4 and 5, and clear, 6 and 5. So that part of the game, pretty good. Guyrie looking pretty good in the goal, Dave. So far, had a number of opportunities and has come up with some good saves.
Zilberti feeding it outside. A hard shot by Rossi, and there is Jones for the save. He's going to bring it upfield by himself.
Good speed.
Excellent speed.
Really?
And he gives it up, and he takes a shot. Gave it up for Morrill. The cage is open. Syracuse tries to get it up fast. Open net. They've got a defenseman, I believe, back in the cage. And Syracuse can't get an opportunity.
Oh, they may blow this one. You track it down.
And they lose possession altogether on the sideline. Gordy Mapes firing his stick in disgust.
Well, Stuart Jones came out, and you will know you're going to pay the price if somebody can get a shoulder into you. And the problem is that when you're down, now you got to get up, hustle back in. They've got one of those skinny defensive sticks in there trying to do the job, and give a lot of credit to Hopkins, but Syracuse not able to make the pass and get a shot off.
Steve Mitchell comes off. Shannon Chuck behind the cage now. He hands it off to his goalie, Jones. Pietramala going to get some pressure from Mapes. Pietramala brings it across midfield. Dishes it off to Russell. On the far side, it's Wilkins. And we've got a timeout taken by Johns Hopkins.
Timeout.
Just 58 seconds into the second quarter. And Johns Hopkins calls time. We'll be back. Syracuse leads it 5-3. Live lacrosse coming your way on Home Team Sports, part of a lacrosse doubleheader tonight. You'll see indoor professional lacrosse coming up after this one, Washington and Philadelphia. A lot of kinship, by the way, between the cities of Baltimore and Syracuse. Syracuse with a second-year mayor in Tom Young, who Machum travels down to Baltimore to see what was done down there in the way of civic restoration, harbor front.
Well, it's a great place to be if you've ever been down there.
Syracuse is leading here 5-3. Hopkins taking a timeout less than a minute into the second quarter. Obviously, Don Zimmerman saw something he wanted corrected in a hurry. Burt battling with Wood.
Yeah.
And there's Kelly with a head of steam laying one on Burt. And Syracuse picks it up. And a player is dumped on the sideline. Chris Bedwini goes down.
Legal hit. Syracuse loses possession. Bedwini on the right side. And we'll see one of those hits. There's Kelly coming there.
Scaramuzzino tried to retaliate against Wood. And everything was clean.
Up a little high, but that's the way it is in this game. It's so fast, you don't see everything. Here's the...
Chanichuk.
Got it on the side, so that's all legal.
Hopkins. Brendan Kelly against Scaramuzzino. Steve took the angle away from him. Morrill is guarded by O'Donnell behind the cage. Bouvier's in front.
They got almost an isolation out here.
Here comes Chanichuk, changing directions once, twice. Looks for the shot, scores! And we have ourselves a 5-4 game as the Hopkins band strikes it up on the near sideline.
Number 22, Bedwini, not able to stop Chanichuk. And they had three people on the crease. They popped one out. They got the ball to Chanichuk. And there it is right there. Ball up over the stick side of Guyrie. Right there. There's the move inside.
Bouvier, a big target right in front.
Yeah, and then now Bouvier moves out of the way as he moves and jumps. Nice play by Bouvier.
Off the faceoff, Donahue gets it ahead to Kavanaugh. Syracuse may elect to shoot quickly. Gordy Mapes on the save by Jones. And the rebound over the top of the cage. And Lilly is being bothered as he comes out and he loses it. Syracuse gets it.
I would say right now that Jones has settled down and is really having a much better game than maybe we thought he might at the beginning in the first quarter as the scoring got going early. And I think Jones is now settled right down, feels at home in there, and has had a couple of nice saves.
Stuart Jones, 5'8 senior out of Lock Raven. Syracuse with a one-goal lead. Pressure being put on by Damon Stewart. Shot taken from the point and deflected. There's Stewart against Kavanaugh. And a whistle.
that's a pick. Damon Stewart moving to screen, and that's illegal. Syracuse gets possession back. Zilberti, way over on the right, is going to bring the ball, and he gets it to number 9, Jim Egan, a freshman.
Egan, big player, has it knocked out of his stick. Pietramala and Zilberti go for it. Syracuse player was in the crease.
Now, there were three people. Egan moved, but he couldn't get rid of the ball quickly enough. They had three Johns Hopkins defensemen just collapsed on him, and he was in the crease.
One name we haven't mentioned as of yet, the now graduated Tom Corey, left with a Syracuse record of 56 goals a year ago. And if there was a designated shooter, Corey was it.
Syracuse putting a little more pressure on now, and they are going to watch Jones, number 18, who took it up before. Now they got it over to a midi. It's
Ledoyen with a long rush. Scaramuzzino was playing him. Now it's Zilberti against Pat Russell. And Russell gets it back. And a technical of sorts is called.
I'm not sure exactly what it was. Syracuse must have been offsides. It looks like they're just running back onsides. That was the signal, so the flag was down. Syracuse once again, a penalty.
So a number of opening game mistakes by both teams. 5-4 is the score. Syracuse has led right from the start, scoring 12 seconds in. Make it 22 seconds in. Stolen away by Scaramuzzino. Can he control it? Momentarily gets a second chance. Just trying to bat it ahead this time. Wood is in pursuit. John Wilkins picks it up.
Well, they're at a real disadvantage with those big sticks trying to. Now, this should be off Hopkins.
Oh, and a procedure call.
Against Pert. And you can see the fans not pleased with the call. Perhaps he stepped on a stick or his foot at any rate. Syracuse not able to get that transition game going.
Exactly what is illegal procedure in this sport?
Well, you could be stepping on somebody's stick. There are a number of things. It covers a multitude of sins.
Hopkins looking now for the equalizing goal. And Brian Wood shoots and scores, and the game is tied at 5. Exactly 11 minutes to go in the first half, and Brian Wood has tied the game at 5. So Brian Wood has his second goal of the game. We've got ourselves a new contest as Hopkins has tied the game at 5-5.
Wood does, this is nothing fancy. They're just trying to screen Guyrie, and there's the shot. And he could not handle that. It was high to his stick side. And it's now, as you said, Dave, 5 apiece. Syracuse transition game has not been able to really do much for him in their settled down offense. It's been a while. Now they got a chance.
Bill Dirgil on the faceoff against Gunning. Gunning comes back to control it, loses it. Dirgil picks it up. Now it's Chris Rossi, 21. Dirgil is going to head toward the Syracuse bench, faking it, and now departing. Peter Allen's going to come on, and the ball is errantly thrown and into the Syracuse bench. On a turnover, Hopkins gets it with a chance to take the lead.
A lot of errant passes and inability to control the tempo of the game as Hopkins has really been able to cash in on the Syracuse mistakes. There's a long pass.
And it's taken cleanly by Pietramala.
He's already
dealing
had
it
one
back
goal.
To Brendan Kelly.
And they wait till they get onside now.
Syracuse had an early 4-1 lead. Here comes Brian Wood, who tied the game up. Now let's see if he'll shoot Hopkins into the lead. He's being pressured by Burke.
Yeah, he's playing without a stick.
Bubier lost the stick. And Syracuse gets the ball.
Watch what happens. There's the ground ball. There's the stick. And then Bubier gets in the way of a Syracuse player. And
it was Chris Bird who knocked the stick right out of the hands. Now up the sideline, here comes Dan Pratt. Stopping in midfield, getting it across. Nice move by Cavanaugh. He stopped on a dime. Another nice move by Curry.
Yeah, Damon Stewart took a run at him, 35. He's picked up somebody else now as Mitchell's out on him. But
this is Zolberti. Set season's records for goals and assists by a freshman. Not a particularly good shot and a good save, though, made by Stuart Jones. He comes out of that cage and throws it away, intended for Wilkins.
Good hustle by Zolberti to really put the pressure on and make him think that there's somebody down. They're not going to give it up easily, and the pass was errant, and Syracuse now picks it up. Zolberti had a little problem with his arm, had a blood clot. They thought he missed a week of practice, but they say he's in such good shape that it really doesn't bother him in that respect.
John Zolberti, blank so far in the game. Gets special attention from Pietramala. Now he works himself free and overthrows the man in front, Nelson. Out it goes. And a push. Or no push.
No push.
Diving attempt by Todd Curry. Hopkins will have it. 9 minutes, 9 seconds to play in the first half.
You know, the crowd isn't in this yet. Syracuse is really not able to establish a tempo. It's 5-5, but the crowd just seems to be strangely silent, waiting for that offensive explosion that they have been used to for so many years.
There are many in the crowd, though, who have come from Hopkins territory, which may account for some of the control of the home field crowd.
Oh, open.
Hopkins with an errant pass, and both teams committing opening game mistakes.
Brian Wood moved very well without the ball, made a fake, was open, had his stick up, but the ball was not on target. Syracuse will now attempt to clear. Game has kind of settled down now into a game of errant passes for the last couple of
This is a slower tempo than Syracuse likes to play and usually plays. But credit Hopkins with their defense in forcing that. In the middle of the field, Syracuse now with Todd Curry under a head of steam, and his shot is just wide. But the Orange will keep it.
Curry, left-handed shot, showed the speed that he's got. Not happy with his placement. It was wide to his right, to Jones's left, but they will get another opportunity. There's Zilberti dealing.
Against Shannon, Chuck. He get called for warding off?
Yep, Pietramala actually made the call for the official, and he was right. The arm was up, and it was right in front of at least Walt Munsey, the official on the far side, felt it was a ward.
So John Zilberti gets the benefit of the up-close and personal explanation, and he heads toward the Syracuse bench. 8:20 to play in this first half. It's been a while now since Syracuse has scored.
Again, trying to put a little pressure on this Hopkins clear. Pietramala with the long pass.
8 minutes and 20 seconds ago. The goal by Greg Burns, the last Syracuse score.
Chanenchuk's now got the ball.
Moving against Bedwini, and Burt comes over. Shot is faked by Wood. And Bubier separated by Pratt, but he regains the ball and loses it a second time. Ahead it goes to Burt. He can't control it, and Kelly has it. And Kelly pays the price. And it's picked up by Syracuse. Jim McNamara, now the crowd into it.
Yeah, that's what they're looking for something to yell about. Syracuse.
Todd Curry. Nelson spotting Todd Curry.
See, they look to Curry. He's going to settle things down. He's going to set them up and run things the way Coach Simmons wants it done. Now Kavanaugh in, the first midfield in. Curry, nice move.
Spin under. Ooh. And a duck under, and it's deflected, and who's going to get it?
Syracuse
will keep it. An appeal being made by Jones to the official to no avail. And we'll get a timeout taken by Syracuse. 7:11 to go in the second quarter, and we're tied at 5-5. That's the Hopkins pep band playing in the stands. And look at the crowd in the upper deck.
They don't usually open the upper deck. They don't usually open the other side, but I would say they've got 12,000 people easy.
I believe this would be the biggest crowd to see a lacrosse game here in the Carrier Dome. I've never seen that many people in the upper deck. Syracuse and Hopkins are tied at 5 apiece. 7:11 to go. Syracuse owns the ball. They're dressed in white. Dave Cohen, Dale Dreipulcher, Gordy Mapes making a move against Greg Lilly. Outside, Rhett Kavanaugh. He's guarded by Webster. Changing directions. Beating Webster. Shoveling it back. Ooh. And a great save by Jones. He had his eye on it all the way, and he outlets it quickly. Intended for Mitchell. Bubier and Mitchell. Those are some wide bodies. Here comes Dan Pratt back for Syracuse. Dishing it off. Ooh. Out they go, and Kavanaugh fakes the shot. He's got tremendous balance, nearly down on his knee.
Oh,
Curry has it now.
Step.
What happened?
He stepped outside the box, and that as soon as you do that, you no longer have flag down. That causes the whistle to be blown, and they'll assess the penalty. And that was a mistake as they stepped on the line. Actually, it was well over the line, and Todd Curry made a mistake. So I say made a mistake. It stopped the play. Watch where his foot is. Oh, yeah, he's outside the box.
There's that save made moments ago by Jones.
He is, as I said, he has really come on strong in this second quarter. He has made a number of good saves that I think a little bit nervous early. He settled right down.
Syracuse does have the man advantage now.
Yeah, they're up 30 seconds. The only reason they could have continued to play like that on the fast break, or excuse me, the flag down, but he was outside the box. So they'll run it down, still say a shot.
Curry's shot was deflected. Chris Rossi ran it down. Now Syracuse looks to get back in the offense.
Oh.
As Zilberti got a neat feed inside. And the deflection will keep it still in possession of the Orange.
Once again, Jones, I think with a chest up on that one. See if we can see where it stops. They feed the crease. There's the shot. Knocked the ball down to his right. Some part of the stick. but he has come on strong.
Yeah, it looked like he got the shaft of the stick, the goalie stick, with a save. Here's Mapes again. Once more played by Lilly. Zilberti behind the cage now. Pietramala is with him.
We're all even.
Zilberti, he's crafty. Behind the back shot.
Going to be a race.
And it's going to belong still to Syracuse.
Good hustle.
5:39 to go.
Good hustle by Webster. Defenseman, 46, could not beat Syracuse to the line as the ball went out. And Burns back in, the man who got his first goal.
And that's the last goal Syracuse tallied. It was still in the first quarter.
Zilberti, what's the whistle here?
Thought I saw a slash indication. That's what it'll be. Zilberti appears to be frustrated early on.
I think so.
1 minute penalty on Syracuse. So 11, John Zilberti slashing.
Syracuse now will be man down.
Slashing.
Hopkins has had four attempts on man up, has not made one yet. So they're 0 for 3. This will be their fourth attempt.
You get the idea Zilberti is a marked man after the start he had last year against Hopkins?
I think they know who he is, and they certainly weren't going to let him.
Even the number change hasn't disguised things. John Wilkins, they swing it to Wood. Now they're working around beautifully. Bubier.
Oh, nice move.
Out to Wood. He's left free. His shot is in there. And Johns Hopkins grabs the lead for the first time at 6-5. On the goal by Brian Wood, his third of the game.
Nice placement by Wood. They swung the ball around and Wood was up on the outside. Watch. There's the pass. And Wood just cranks. And he got the pass from Jeff Iam, number 21. There's Iam, watch. He knows what he's doing on this man up as they try to slide, but
Brian Wood.
They got it by Geary on the right-hand side.
Goal by number 15, Wood.
Iam gets the assist. Johns Hopkins with their first lead of the game at 6-5.
Hopkins 6, Syracuse 5.
So Hopkins has wiped out the early Syracuse lead. That was 4-1. And they now, for the moment, have the lead at 6-5.
Gunning pushed on the faceoff, so Syracuse get the ball. And it has been a while since Syracuse has scored. Nice
two-man game, Mapes, and it's tied up. Nelson and Mapes. And you won't see that play very often. Mapes is actually running, heading toward the opposite goal as he got that pass, and then just rolled it under the legs of Jones.
Give and go. They really got nice timing on that. There's the give's already been made, and there is the go, and Nelson put it perfectly to Mapes, and Mapes put it right by Jones. Great timing, and it happened that quickly. As we said, Syracuse has been a while, and they get right back in it. That's what's so great about lacrosse. It happens so quickly. You can get down 3, 4, 5 goals. Look what happened last year when Syracuse played at Hopkins. So this game is very, very tight, obviously. 6 apiece, 4:56 left, and we get a whistle.
The face was between Gunning and Durjo. Procedure signal this time against Hopkins.
Gunning got called again. I don't know what he was doing, but he did something illegal on the face because the whistle was blown almost immediately. He and Durgill had a little bit of a shoving match after the last faceoff.
And now Syracuse will look to regain the lead. Game having been tied at 5 and now 6.
Gait.
Close. One of the Gait brothers with a great fake. And he scores. That's number 38, Gary Gait, with his first U.S. college goal.
Whoa, they play hockey up there in Canada, but you can see the moves. I can imagine him with a hockey puck because he made a lot of moves. Watch him. Watch him go left-handed. Webster was, look, there's one down. Oh, boy. And nobody picked him up. He just waltzed right through the crease, by the crease, didn't get in the crease, and took a point-blank shot after making three fakes.
And so Roy Simmons has dividends from a couple of newcomers early on, Greg Burns and now Gary Gait. And Durgill and company knocked the ball toward the far sideline and out.
Syracuse ball. Syracuse doing very well on faceoffs today.
Peter Allen comes on along with Todd Curry. Webster comes on, Mike Webster for Johns Hopkins.
.433 left as they try to get their motion offense going a little bit.
Stewart, Lilly, Pietramala on defense. Syracuse looks to go up by two. The feet in front. Score! Peter Allen from Gordy Mapes.
Syracuse been moving some combinations around, and Gordy Mapes and Nelson have really added a lot. There's the shot by 15, Peter Allen. He's only a sophomore, but it was Mapes who got the assist. Beat him stick side.
And that means three goals in 33 seconds. So they were down 6-5, and now they're up 8-6. Three goals in 33 seconds. And it's Durgill winning the face again. He had a goal earlier. Redirecting way back to Jim Guiry.
O'Donnell now is going to handle it.
Morrow's going to take a shot at him. Guiry's out of the cage. He may be blindsided. And Bubier just missed him.
Syracuse, good effective clear using Guiry. Got rid of it. But
4 minutes to go in this half. Here comes Curry. May have been held momentarily from behind.
Well, they've got two men on him. Somebody should be open. That's what he was looking for. Now Hopkins settles down.
Gait to Curry. Curry spins for the angle, and his shot is high and hard and over the top.
You know what that was? That was at Jones, I'm still out here, here it comes shot, because he wasn't really on, but he knew he had backup, and he just took a cranker, and they're trying to get at Jones' confidence. As you said, three goals in 33 seconds. Very explosive, both teams.
Here's Tom Nelson, played by Pietramala, works free of him, coming right in. They take the angle away from his knees, out to Gait. Gates shot, save. I don't know if that was the goalie or
Jones,
a defenseman
yeah.
out in front. Pietramala, and Syracuse will keep it. They out-hustled Hopkins.
Well, Jones was out fast, but could not beat him to the line. Good hustle, but Hopkins got to do a little thinking here. They had Syracuse down, starting to work on him, and Mapes and Nelson and feeding and Gait, they really have come on strong.
Paul Gait is on now, as well as Gary Gait. Gordy Mapes fights off some body defense.
Kavanaugh. Nice check by Kavanaugh.
Gets it back, kept it alive. Nelson, if he can beat two men, he'd have a clear avenue.
Well, they've got Hopkins has jumped a couple times. They've had two men on one Syracuse player. Syracuse is just waiting to make the dump and trying to get the crowd in the game.
And the Syracuse bench getting this crowd to stand and get into it as Greg Burns goes one-on-one. Has a man in front. He didn't see him. Nope. He had Kavanaugh all alone in front, and he took the shot, but Syracuse will still keep it.
Well, Chicharino and Damon Stewart were both on him, and they are not hesitating to jump and put two-on-one at the last minute, hoping that Syracuse won't be able to make the dump. Syracuse has got 24 shots. Hopkins, 15.
That may have been a freshman mistake as Burns drew the double team, and there was a man left all alone in front.
Well, that's what we said. That's what they're looking for.
And here's Mapes.
Oh!
Gordy Mapes came out of the left corner, and he beat Jones again.
Greg Lilly, 37, not able to get on the stick for Hopkins. And as we said, Mapes and company have really given him a shot in the arm.
Syracuse
nice pass.
On a score by number three,
he beat John Wilkins.
See the pass? Right there.
Yeah, that looked like a set play because it looks like Mapes lulled him to sleep in the corner while they cleared out, and he just beat him one-on-one.
And they got an assist from Gait, so the Gait brothers making an impact as freshmen here. And Syracuse, now Durgill, something with the ball.
Which Gait was it?
38.
That's Gary Gait.
Yep, they're twin brothers. All the way from Canada, British Columbia province. And freshman making a contribution early.
2.5 minutes to go in the first half. Don't forget at halftime, we'll meet Brian Wood and Todd Curry, each a performer on the World Cup team for the United States. And here's Brian Wood, who was injured early.
Well, lots of cuts and stuff on the crease. They're really trying to put the pressure on the Syracuse defense. They're stacking people on the crease and then really doing a lot of moving and picking.
Whistle away from the ball as Iam was working with it.
Yeah, and Iam got detected on a ward this time. So Syracuse will get the ball.
Real big shift in momentum in this game after Hopkins grabbed a quick 6-5 lead.
Almost, they kind of lulled you down. The crowd wasn't in, everything was down, and Syracuse just seemingly making some changes, got some different people in, and really things started to click offensively for them. Now how they clear, Guyrie in this clear for Syracuse. They're going to guard him, force the long pass to O'Donnell. No, they don't. They cut it off.
Over the middle, it's Peter Allen. Neil Alt, number 8, is in the game.
Uh-oh, fast break.
Can't be handled, however, initially. And there's a marker down as the ball was in precarious position in terms of the Syracuse defense. Jeff Iam was closing in.
Well, that was a great jump for Hopkins, but that was one of those basketball fouls. Do anything to stop him from the free shot on the goalie. And there's Pratt, 36. There's one foul, and that stopped the initial shot one-on-one. And here's another one. And you'll see the next flag come out. I don't know if they're down two men. Let's check here. 2, 4, 5, 8. Yep. They're down two.
And don't forget, those of you watching live on Home Team Sports, more lacrosse coming up after this one. Indoor box lacrosse. Washington and Philadelphia.
Well, Syracuse is now two men down. The last time they Wood took the shot, they're going to take it right there. Yeah.
Wilkins.
No.
And back there is Iam.
Wilkins is a sophomore, 6'2", 185. Good size, took a left-handed shot. They really...
Neither team, as you can see, very successful in these man-up situations. Oh. But there is Wilkins getting the goal. And Hopkins cuts into the Syracuse lead. It's now 9-7.
As we said, Wilkins is a big kid, and he cranked that upper just underneath the pipe, and Jim Guyrie felt he should have had it. But they were two men down, but watch. Look at this shot. Look where he sends that from left field, and we have trouble even slowing it down on slow motion replay. So Wilkins with a big left-handed crank brings Hopkins to within two at 9-7 with 1:24 left in the first half. Faceoffs now important as Syracuse would like to retain some momentum. Hopkins would like to get a couple more goals and send Syracuse in at halftime without any confidence.
It's golfed ahead by Durgel and out of bounds. By the way, that goal by John Wilkins, as Durgel has a bloodied up knee, as you can see. Wilkins, a player from Long Island, from Ward Melville High School, a sophomore. Durgel's going to get some repair
Wood,
done.
Fast
here comes
break.
Wood with a minute 15 to go. Wood with a great change of direction and a deflection high in the air by Guyrie. Hopkins will keep it.
Boy, you can see how good number 15 is as Brian Wood just up. He's got great speed. He and Curry remind me of each other.
Look at the strength of Bubier, but they knock it out of his stick. Pratt rolled it ahead. Loose on the ground with 55 to go. It's going to be orange ball.
Well, Syracuse, as we said, up by two. Hopkins scrapping for the ball. It went off a Blue Jay stick. Syracuse will get a chance to clear. Pratt, 36 with the ball. O'Donnell, 31, a defenseman, trots over to take position. Coach Zimmerman.
And here comes Rhett Kavanaugh against the retreating Steve Mitchell. And we're going to have a timeout taken by Syracuse with 48 seconds to go. They have possession of the ball, and they'd like one more score before halftime, leading it now 9-7 in a seesaw affair. We have seen Hopkins lead once at 6-5, and Syracuse lead throughout.
You know, it's interesting. I see right away that Roy Simmons III, who we said is now coaching at a small Division III school, here today his team is not playing. He's helping out. He went right after Guyrie when they came out. He wants to tell him, look, that was a shot by Wilkins. You're two men down. Don't let it bother you, because he doesn't want him to lose his confidence. Jones, on the other hand, had a little shaky in the first quarter, came on very, very strong in the second quarter until Syracuse collapsed on him with those three goals in 33 seconds, Dave.
That's it, Dale, and Those fans down in the Baltimore area watching on Home Team Sports getting a good look here at the Carrier Dome, which is just a marvelous facility, especially for lacrosse where you get a true bounce. The field is completely flat. There's no crown on the field. You don't need one for any runoff of water. Some of the Hopkins fans in the colors of Johns Hopkins, and looks like a pillow or a quilt.
Yeah, it does.
The ceiling here.
Well, when you get two good teams here, this shows you that you can get a lot of people in to watch lacrosse. And everybody enjoying themselves here today.
And for those people who came up from the Baltimore area, they saw a winter day that is unlike many Syracuse has had.
Very untypical.
We close saw the to sun. 70 degrees.
Syracuse probably running a set play.
Greg Burns with it now. Clock is down to 35 seconds. Burns finds Curry in a crowd. He shoots, he scores. What a blast off the stick of Todd Curry.
Whoa. It didn't stay there very long. Burns with the pass. Burns not playing like a freshman. He really really controls that stick. And there's Burns, 14. And he just went stick side, but he had Jones had not slid over yet. He was still guarding the left side, his left side, and not able to get over there quick enough, and they got by him for a three-goal lead with 34 seconds left.
That is the third goal of the game by Todd Curry. Brian Wood also has three. Gordy Mapes has two.
There's Wood.
Ryan Wood looking to dish it off. Somebody pushes him from behind very deliberately.
Well, you
and
know.
It was Jim McNamara getting back, rushing back to try to prevent Wood, who had a real head of steam from getting that shot off.
He's so fast. He reminds me of Curry. That right there's a hold. I think that's what they eventually called. I'm not sure. I'll check in a second. But what I was going to say is they would rather play a man down than to give Wood a fast break opportunity like that, because he's such a good lacrosse player, at least in that situation. So they give up a man, and the last time this happened, number 17, John Wilkins, cranked from the same position he's in.
Now let's see if Hopkins can beat the clock. Down to 15 seconds to go. When will they initiate their offense?
I think they're going to look for Wilkins.
Down to 7 seconds. They're not into it yet. 5 seconds, and they're going the wrong way.
They may just hold on to the ball and get the faceoff. That's exactly what they're going to do.
So they did not get a shot away. Ryan Wood gesturing to Larry LeDoyen as the first half has come to a close here in the Carrier Dome. Syracuse leads it 10-7. We'll be back to talk to both Ryan Wood and Todd Curry right after this. Welcome back to the Carrier Dome. At halftime, Syracuse leads Johns Hopkins by a 10-7 score. It's been a game of spurts, Dale Dreipulcher. Syracuse jumped out to a very, very quick 1-0 lead. Hopkins tied it up seconds later in the first minute of the game. We had a 1-1 tie, and then Syracuse jumped out to a 4-1 lead. Hopkins went up eventually 6-5, and then Syracuse, 3 goals, 33 seconds, and they have the 10-7 lead at the half.
It was like three games. It started off like it was going to be a real run-and-shoot contest. Then it slowed down. Syracuse made some mistakes, lost the ball. Hopkins took advantage of them, got back in the game. And then when that 3 goals in 33 seconds, I think Syracuse got some individual matchups that they were looking for. And when they got the people in the position they wanted, it just all seemed to click. And Jones, who'd been playing very well, just had point-blank shots taken at him. So he had some problems there, but it wasn't all his fault.
We've got some highlights of the first half action. We're going to take a look at some of the goals now and let you see what's happened here in the first half. Johns Hopkins with the ball now. And this is going to be the hard shot of Brian Wood.
Just took that right-hand shot, beat Guyery. Syracuse now, this is one of the goals that they started that off with. That's Mapes.
Off the feet from Tom Nelson.
Yeah, Nelson. They got some new names in there that people running from the attack. And then they got the Haight brothers involved. And that's Allen's goal right there, number 15.
Off the assist from Gordy Mapes. Peter Allen with a late goal.
That's right. And once again, Jones is just getting point-blank shots taken at him in that series. Not much that he can do about it. There's the pass. once again, point blank, Mapes, number three, picked up another goal, and that was the three goals in 33 seconds. And of course, you know, that's got to shake your confidence a little bit. I'm not sure about the goalie so much as perhaps the close-in defense had trouble picking people up. There's the shot. Syracuse got 26 shots to 18 for Hopkins. Saves, as I said, Jones came on very, very strong. 13 saves, 10 for Guyrie. Ground ball, Syracuse gobbled some up, 27 to 18.
And Todd Curry said something there in our halftime interview. He said, in central New York, they like to play the speed-up, fast-break kind of game down south in the Maryland area. They prefer the six-on-six, and Syracuse has functioned best in that rapid offense, and Hopkins has scored in the half field or set-up offense.
And Syracuse has also done well the face-off, which helps set that fast-break game up. If you can get a fast-break off a face-off, there you go. And Syracuse done a good job of face-off, something they had a little problem with last year.
Second half face-off coming right up. Dave Cohen and Dale Dreipulcher with you from the Carrier Dome in Syracuse as you watch it live on Home Team Sports. Individually, Brian Wood leading Johns Hopkins. He has three goals, one apiece for Pietramala, Wilkins, Chanichuk, and Morrill. And for Syracuse, they're led in scoring by Todd Curry with three goals. Gordy Mapes is two. One goal for Peter Allen, one for Greg Burns, one for Bill Dirgel, one for Gait. That is Gary Gait, number 38.
The Gait brothers, we said freshmen getting some early playing time for Syracuse out of British Columbia.
Always one of the best places to watch a lacrosse game from, the end zone, but not one of the safest. So
that's right.
They don't allow people in the end zones. Our cameraman is pretty safe. He's in the third deck.
Well, it'll be interesting to see how this second half progresses. As I mentioned, Syracuse doing a pretty good job of getting the faceoffs, and if you can control that and start a fast break from that, that's great, and that's their style.
Hopkins will have it here to begin the second half. Remember, they possession of the ball at the end of the first half, and the man-up situation elected not to take a shot.
Well, you know, when Syracuse had been getting more faceoffs, probably the smart thing to do. They control it right now, and they're going to get to take a quick shot. And they get right away. They hit. Bubier wheels and fires, and he gets it right by Guyrie. 5 seconds gone in the third quarter. Craig Bubier.
Well, you can't have a much better start than that.
Absolutely not. And he is wide open. And he beats Guyrie low. Looks like it deflected off maybe the inside of his foot. Went into the cage.
Now the face-off again. It's Pat Donahue out there for Syracuse. Greg Gunning for Hopkins. Donahue wins it cleanly. And he guns it upfield to Curry. Todd Curry, number 16. Going over the head of the official to John Zilberti, who's been blank so far. Back he goes to Curry. Syracuse running a stack there right in front of the goal.
Well, they had been running a 2-2-2, and then they seem to get a little bit with Gordy Mapes and company in from behind.
Donahue not able to go after the rolling move. Now it's in the stick of Kavanaugh. Back out to Donahue for the low hard shot.
That came back in.
Syracuse keeps it.
Hopkins getting some people in the game. Mike Webster, defenseman in.
Wood is checked out. Wood injured an ankle early, but is shaking off the effects of that. He's come back to score. Greg Burns, number 14.
Defensive midfield in for Hopkins now.
And a goal, unbelievably, by Gordy Mapes, who had a man draped over his back, Pietramala. And Syracuse takes an 11-8 lead.
Mapes very excited. I couldn't believe he got the shot off. Let's see who it was. I think it was Lilly. There, Lilly, 37, was riding him right into the crease. He got the shot off before he was pushed in. Pietramala came over to help out, but watch 37 right there. It's Greg Lilly, and he is all over Mapes. Got the stick in. Looked like Mapes maybe was holding on to his stick a little bit.
You're right about that. It was Lilly who was draped all over him. Pietramala there for late defensive help. But Gordy Mapes now has his third goal of the game, and Syracuse has the three-goal lead.
Hopkins gets the face-off, redirects down. Jones will handle it, chased by Zilberti.
Hopkins trying to come out of their own end. Lilly sends it to Jones up the sideline for Pietramala. He dumps it ahead and over the head of Pat Russell. Down low it goes. Bubier on the sideline stays in bounds.
Good stick. Pratt on Bubier. I thought that ball might go, but Bubier, nice job. Big size difference. He's got 5 inches on Pratt.
Bubier spinning a couple of times. And now Ciccarone. John Ciccarone did not play a year ago, back after a sabbatical. Works free for the shot. It's loose. They can't spot it. Bubier is there. And now Syracuse has control, momentarily at least. Ciccarone.
Nice job by Ciccarone. Really kept the ball in play. Good body check. Really hit hard, but he couldn't control it. But Hopkins does, and number nine will bring it in. Bubier, the big 6'3". There's the shot down. And Ciccarone out of the crease, but Hopkins controls.
Bubier Pratt. Against Pratt. Now Ciccarone feeds the crease, and a score by Morrill. Mike Morrill connects his second goal of the game, and it's now Syracuse 11 and Hopkins 9.
O'Donnell, 31, not able to stay with Morrill. Morrill shook him free, shook himself free, I should say. And Jim Guyrie unable to stop that, a left-handed shot. And as you said, Dave, brings Hopkins within two at 11-9, 13-03, and another faceoff.
And off this faceoff, Gunning is down and hurt. Gunning is down and hurt. His glove has come off. He looks like he may have injured a hand. And now they spot Gunning on the ground, and they will stop play.
Yeah, he went down real fast, and he may have, the glove is off. He may have taken a shot on that hand.
He got tied up off the faceoff. And bodies went flying, and as he landed, the glove came off, and he was very obviously hurt.
The near side official did not see him go down. The far side official, let's see if we can pick up, see what happens. There's the ground ball. He comes through with the stick. The glove's off. I think he hurt it on the collision. It wasn't as a result of the glove going off. He really took a shot on that wrist or the elbow. Maybe a... Well, I don't want to say what it is, but it, you know, they're looking at the shoulder. Possible separation, maybe a bruise, but he is not a result of losing the glove. It happened before that.
We will come back and update you on the injury to Greg Gunning right after this. Back here in the Carrier Dome, the injured Greg Gunning is now being helped to the sideline. And I doubt whether we will see any further action from him, so Hopkins will have to come up with another faceoff man.
We're going to look at it again. He comes through to hit, and it's the left arm. Looks like he just jammed it right in there. Now it may be a bruise. Looking at the shoulder, they're holding the shoulder up. I don't know whether it's the hand. I think it's the hand. I think he may have done something to that hand, either a bruise or perhaps a break.
Here's the move by Chanichuk. Gets pressure from Badwini. Spins free. Gets the angle for the shot. Overshoots Brian Wood. Hopkins, Bubier is down. And here comes Wood trying to separate Burt from the ball. Doesn't get a shot at him. Not yet, at least. It's loose. Could be trouble. Bubier fell hard to the floor, but he's up and okay. And a loose ball goes right into the net. No, it just missed. It rolled about 50 yards. Zilberti was closest to it. Zilberti has it. He has not scored a point in the game.
Syracuse is going to make some changes. They get Curry in, and now they're going to get Kavanaugh in.
Badwini, Scaramuzzino depart. Donahue comes on as well with Kavanaugh. Here comes Curry. Likes to work from this side of the field, and he scores again. Todd Curry with his fourth goal of the game. Two in the first quarter, one each in the second and third. And now Syracuse leads it 12-9.
And he just motors. All it is speed. Nobody really picks him up. Kelly was closest to him, 32. But nothing happened. He just came up with a nice bouncer, a high bouncer, went up into the net. And that's going to give Syracuse now a three-goal lead with 11:52. And that's the speed we talked about. Very, very difficult to stop Curry when he is going full speed, and nobody came out to really get up on him, Dave.
And we've got a delay as a barrage of oranges has been tossed onto the field, ostensibly from the upper deck, from the way the fans are looking.
Now, that's just doesn't make any sense at all. My goodness, you got a great lacrosse game here, and people trying to indicate who it is so that they can be ejected.
Wasn't that fellow. All right, back to the action. A face-off. Syracuse leading Hopkins 12-9. Excellent lacrosse game. Opener for both teams. And what's the call? As Dergil, who does a lot of dirty work, is at the bottom of the pile.
Face-offs now relatively even. 12-10, I think that should be if our stats are correct. 12-10 for the face-off department. Syracuse has come up with some key ones. Right now, Syracuse is going to work Rossi.
Mike Webster, 46, plays him. Now Gordy Mapes, guarded by Lilly. And the cutter is Nelson, splitting the defense.
He's
trying
to get
the angle. Here's a shot, and it's wide, but Syracuse keeps it.
They have got Mapes way down. Now Mapes is going to bring the ball in.
With Lilly against him.
He had good luck feeding, and now he's going to go back up on top and gives the ball off to Nelson.
Neil Alton, front number eight, from behind the cage.
Give and go. They tried
that little
again.
Give and go earlier. They were successful with Mapes and Nelson. Not that time. Alt kicks it ahead, and it rolls across the sidelines out of bounds. Johns Hopkins will get the ball. Down by 12 tonight, 11-12 to play.
That was off of Syracuse, as you said, to Hopkins hustling as the ball was kicked ahead, I believe, by Alt, and they will get the ball at about the 40-yard line on this football field, which is also now lined for lacrosse, obviously. Wood gets the ball in. Brendan Kelly handles it.
Five of the Syracuse 12 goals have been assisted. The rest have been unassisted. And here's a mishandled pass in close by Ciccarone, and a big hit put on by Wood. Gets it to Brendan Kelly. Kelly in the middle of the field, or trying to go that way at least. Now he spots Chan and Chuck. You know, senior out of Farmingdale, Long Island.
It's a good time to talk about how well he plays both ends of the
Bubier
field.
Wood really didn't get good aluminum on that one.
And he's going to ward. When you're 6'3 and you got some 5'10 guys down there hacking at you, the tendency might be to just push them out of the way. And he was called for a ward. We've had three warding calls in this game.
The Gait brothers come on, along with, for the first time tonight, Keith Owens, a junior college transfer out of Port Washington, New York, on the north shore of Long Island.
Played for Nassau Community College, was a two-year All-American. Right now, O'Donnell, 31, is going to handle the ball. Syracuse working carefully on the clear. They've got a lot of people in.
McNamara up the far sideline. Spots Gary Gait. This is Paul Gait with his back to you, number 39.
Damon Stewart in also for Hopkins. Dave Howland, 27 in. So we're getting some new faces as they're going to make a big run here in the second half. They want to make sure everybody's got their legs.
Nelson has it. James DiTomaso, number 41, is on the field defensively. And DiTomaso has it now.
Pushed down, took the shot from the ground. No good. Hopkins up with it.
Lilly getting it ahead for Howland. Damon Stewart rushing in, number 35. They can't spot him.
Morrill on O'Donnell. He's had some luck.
And here's Morrill. He likes to work on this side. He goes out, intended for Ledoyen. Feed in.
Oh, nice
close
move.
Bubier got the top, got the crossbar. Rebound, Ledoyen. And bodies flying, sticks flying, fans roaring. Stop of play.
Now they're going to call Burt for an illegal check. And he really hit Ledoyen. And Syracuse will be down for a minute. There's the feed. It was kind of deflected at Bubier. There's the shot off the pipe. then deflected. So Syracuse will be manned down. Let's see if we can pick up the... That's not even the hit, I don't think, is it?
Brian Wood. Wilkins is on. Wilkins has a goal. Here's Morrill. Again, Wilkins, and now Wood out at the point. Ledoyen gets it back.
Wilkins and Wood both have a man-up goal, I think.
Oh. And a pretty goal. Coming virtually out of nowhere, Bubier has scored his second goal in this third quarter, and it is now a 12-10 game and 9 minutes to play.
Always amazes me how much speed they can get on that ball as they're running actually away from the goal. Watch Bubier. He's running away. Watch the speed he gets on that, and he really has a pretty goal. Man up for Hopkins. And Hopkins has won two man-up goals. Three man-up goals out of seven. And I think they've spread that around now. Bubier had one, Wilkins.
Let's check the face-off man there. It was number 35, Damon Stewart, in replace of the injured Gunning.
I was just going to say, the next face-off we should check to see. And he had a stick that he used for the face-off. Now he trades and runs back to his midfield position.
John Zilberti's been held in check. Gordy Mapes with Lilly against him. Mapes beat him earlier in this period.
Lilly takes it away from here, puts the ball on the ground.
And Webster's there for the takeaway. Webster up the sideline, released just in time to get it to Lilly, who can't handle it. A push against Donahue, so Johns Hopkins will keep it. It's been a good third quarter for Hopkins. They're down 12-10. At the half, it was a 10-7 game. So to this point, they have cut into the Syracuse lead by one goal.
Syracuse on the out of bounds, not able to keep it in. Hopkins, however, will have to clear. They're in back of the midfield line. Ledoyen gives it to Jones, the goalie, who gets it up right away to Pietramala.
Marker is down on the field. It could be offsides.
Must be Syracuse, yes.
30-second technical offside, Syracuse.
So another error by Syracuse, and now Hopkins.
Have their eighth man-up attempt. They've made three of seven. This will be their eighth.
Hopkins can get within one. They have led only once in the game at 6-5 after being down early 4-1. Wilkins. Now Morrill. Wilkins again. Wood is up top. This is Ledoyen. Morrill. Rotating it counterclockwise. Iam is on, the extra attacker. Bouvier's behind the cage. Wilkins to Wood. He cranks. Saved by Guyery. And sent back to O'Donnell.
Oh, ball on the ground.
O'Donnell dribbles it to Guyery. He's out of the cage. The net is empty. There's the goal by Bouvier. Bouvier scores his third goal of this third quarter, and now it is Syracuse 12 and Hopkins 11. And the Annapolis native Jim Guyery is wondering why.
Well, that wasn't really his fault. The pass was a dangerous pass because Morrill was right there, and he does a great job of checking the ball, and he checks it backwards toward the crease, and Bouvier just used the wrist to put it in. And Jim Guyery, an emotional kid, is upset. And we'll see the save, actually, that he made, first of all, but unable to clear the ball. So faceoffs now become important as Syracuse gets the ball.
And they've got the ball out at midfield and the stick of Todd Curry. Marker is down. Curry behind the cage. Zilberti changing directions on Pietramala.
Now they got to keep it in the box. Oh, that's not going to do it for them. That's going to cost Hopkins. So Syracuse will now be man up. Syracuse has had four attempts, made one on the man up situation.
7:29 to play in this third quarter. Roy Simmons carrying on a dialogue with one of our three game officials. Now we're back to action. Zilberti. And Todd Curry. Greg Burns, number 14. He's had one goal. Up top, Curry with a blazer, and it's held onto and knocked out.
Oh, good hustle.
And
good hustle by
it?
Hopkins.
Hopkins will have it. They were closest to it on the far sideline.
Jeff Eim, well, he had really had position. He was already there, but he did a nice job getting to the sideline and positioning himself as that ball went out of bounds. There he was, Hopkins' ball. They're man down. I don't know how much time is left on the penalty, but I'm sure the man with the ball will be doubled.
And that is Brian Wood. Gets away from that double team, but he loses the ball.
Nice job by Burt and Scaramuzzino. 33 and 19 to pressure Wood into that turnover. 5 seconds, I think, left on the penalty. And Ciccarone is in the box ready to come in. Well, Syracuse is going to have to clear. They may have to redirect. Although they are man up for about 5 seconds. They get it across easily. And everybody's even.
Once again, Zilberti dealing from behind the cage. Here's Kavanaugh changing directions.
Webster on him. Oh,
deflected. And it bounces over the stick of a Syracuse man, but Curry is there.
Boy, they're taking some hard shots in there, and somebody's paying with those deflections.
Off the screen, here's Burns. Jones with a save.
Came in waist high. That's the probably easiest save for a goalie to make. He was not really screened, and he made a nice save. Gets it off to his wing defenseman, and they're going to attempt to clear now.
Stuart Jones triggering the ball upfield for Johns Hopkins. Chris Burt nearly blindsided Chanichuk. McNamara up ahead for Burt. Try the behind-the-back pass, a weak one, but played by Zilberti.
Zilberti's going to have to sprint. He's got two people on him over the head.
He still has control. He feeds in close. Score. And gives Zilberti the assist. John Zilberti finally in the scoring column, at least with the assist.
He hit Egan, and there's the Egan jumped up over Jones and got a clear space over the shoulder. Watch, there's a full speed pass. Looked one way by Zilberti, went back. There's the jump, just up enough to go over the head of Jones. Syracuse Durgle controls the faceoff. Now these faceoffs a little bit more important.
And that's the first collegiate goal for this man, Jim Egan, out of Yorktown Heights, a freshman. Here's Zilberti. Feeding Egan again. Saved by Ault.
Oh.
Ault has it one more time. Flips it back.
Damon Stewart had it for a second, but taken out of his hands again by Ault. Syracuse sets up their offense.
Syracuse has scored in bunches in this game. Neil Ault. Guarded loosely by Damon Stewart. Gives it up. Egan feeding out front. Zilberti deflected, and Egan's going to be closest to it.
Good body. Jones got over there. You said Syracuse scores seem to come in bunches. There's Zilberti with the hair hanging down out of the back of his helmet.
I'll tell you one thing, Dale. There are many, many more people that Syracuse is using this year.
Yeah, you
are.
It's
not a case of using a lot of people in the early season as Chris Rossi scores. Rossi gets his first goal, and once again, as we said, they're coming in bunches. 14 to 11 now with 5:09 to go in this quarter.
Syracuse getting a lot of motion here. Everybody moving. There's the break. There's the cut. Just a simple look like an X cut. And Rossi, 21, quick sticked it by Jones. And as I said, the faceoff seemed to be becoming more important as Syracuse able to control the tempo. And right there, that faceoff got number 21 a goal.
Nine different goal scorers by Syracuse. Remember, Hopkins has lost their faceoff man, Gunning.
That can hurt.
Damon Stewart loses it to Durgill.
Goal by Chris.
That's why I say the faceoffs, especially when you don't have your best man out there, they can become crucial as Syracuse can control the tempo.
Here comes Durgill. He may take it all the way himself. Didn't get a good opportunity. Credit
Damon
the Hopkins
Stewart.
Defense.
Stewart just gets it upfield, get it out of the Hopkins' goal area.
And Syracuse trying to prevent Hopkins from getting to it. A procedure call against O'Donnell.
He held him with a stick. Prevented him from going to the ball, and Morrill made the call. I think it was Morrill. Let's see. Watch what. Yeah, there he goes. Oh, yeah, you can't do that. He turned around to say, hey, did you see that? And he did. Hopkins' ball.
Bubier out to Wood. Wood goes by Burt with a nifty move and a shot deflected. 4:34 to play, third quarter. Syracuse leads Hopkins by three. It's been an uphill struggle all the way for Johns Hopkins. Here is Bubier. He's had a good third quarter. He loses the ball there, however. And Chris Burt.
I think Pratt took it away from him. Burt got the ball up. Now Syracuse has to clear.
McNamara.
Now this is where they don't want to make a mistake like they did and gave up an easy goal to Hopkins. And Bubier got that errant pass, or actually knocked out of the stick of Guyrie.
Ciccaroni's going to apply a little bit of token pressure in the middle. Hopkins is not really a riding or a pressure team. They like to get back in their half field defense. Pat Donahue is in the middle of the field.
Syracuse cleared that quite effectively, quite easily.
Outside Curry. Watched by Webster.
Curry trying to get some motion going. He may just run by Webster.
And his bounce shot is saved by Jones. Flips it ahead in traffic. Damon Stewart eluding an over-the-top attempt. Taken down from behind by Scaramuzzino. Cleanly. Upfield he goes.
Syracuse.
To Egan.
Syracuse
moving it well.
What a
hit. Donahue took a shot in the back from Pietramala. Syracuse still with it. Egan spins. Egan shoots.
Short
and
side.
Jones out of the cage. Lilly in pursuit.
We're going to get a push. Syracuse going to lose possession, but Syracuse really running and running hard, and it looks like Hopkins losing a little bit of their zip. They're only down by three goals, but in terms of running, we didn't see the speed there. Syracuse tracking him down and getting the ball back. But, of course, that helps when you get into faceoffs, too.
Hopkins traveled here with a much smaller squad than Syracuse has dressed, and a good many of the Hopkins players have not seen action.
Well, it's early in the season to have your 60-minute legs, too, so both teams, although appear to be in good condition.
3 minutes to go in this third quarter. Bubier can't handle it, and Pratt gets it to Scaramuzzino. He looks to outlet it back to Pratt. He does. Pratt spots a man in the middle.
It's
another
Burt.
Big stick. It's Burt. Down quickly they get it into scoring position.
Syracuse running. Fast break. They're going to run it off now. Now they leave Burt in with a big stick. Now he's going to run out and be replaced. So Syracuse will slow it down.
Morty Mapes is in control of the ball.
And now they get Curry in.
Damon Stewart comes on as well. Curry has it. Brett Kavanaugh is going to come on the field. Number 13. Gets the feed from Curry.
A lot of people, as you said, seeing action for Syracuse and trying to keep the pressure on Hopkins. Only a three-goal lead for Syracuse. A lot of time left.
Kavanaugh can stop on a dime with great balance, as you saw there.
Yeah, he's taking
Stewart. Kavanaugh went down, got up, went down, got up, still has it. Mapes looked like he was held. Todd Curry gets there, beats Webster. What a move.
Beat Webster bad. Oh, he's going to slow it down. No, he doesn't. He takes a shot, deflected. I think it's a question of Hopkins' defense maybe getting a little bit tired here. Syracuse able to control the action in the Hopkins end of the field. And Hopkins going to get some fresh people in.
There's Tim Nelson, the all-time leading scorer in college lacrosse. But oddly enough, not the leading scorer at Syracuse. That's because he began his career at North Carolina State.
Oh, intercepted.
Intercepted off the feed by Mapes. Shannon Chuck with a long run. Now he gives it up for Ciccaroni, and behind the cage it's Iam, who's on now playing on the attack. Russell and Ledoyen come on for Hopkins. We're down to a minute and 15 seconds to go, third quarter.
Well, you think you don't have to be in shape. They're going to give Shannon Chuck a blow, but boy, he has been hustling, and that's you've got to get tired doing all that he has been doing for Johns Hopkins. Dressel in now, number two.
That's John Dressel. Ledoyen faking. changing directions, dumping it to Russell. 50 seconds to go. Third quarter, Syracuse, 14 to 11.
Syracuse playing good defense.
McNamara wrapping up Ciccaroni. Now Russell. Hopkins may be content to try a one shot here. LaDoyan got a step on Curry. Now they shovel it back to Russell. They're getting in ever so close to the net. Syracuse, now they go outside.
Syracuse doing a good job. Now it's O'Donnell and Morrill. We've seen this matchup before.
Curry and LaDoyan are matched up away from the ball.
15 seconds. Flag.
Curry and LaDoyan.
He says no time. No, he had a flag down.
16 and 14. 16 white, 14 blue. They were going at it away from the action.
Oh, he got him for a slash.
I didn't see the signal,
but Jim O'Hara left no doubt about it when he came over to announce it. It was a slash.
It's on Todd Curry, so he did get detected.
Yeah, it was away. I didn't think that it was at the point of attack. So Syracuse will be manned down. This will be the 10th attempt, I think, for Hopkins.
Todd Curry said he's put on 15 pounds.
Yeah, he looks a little burlier, doesn't he? A little discussion here about what's happening down here.
Doesn't appear as if he's surrendered any speed.
No. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. There, I. Okay, Syracuse one man down after all the discussion. And Wood will be handling the ball.
And in case you're wondering, we have not seen any action yet from Mike Ciano. Ciano played football for Syracuse, a wide receiver for 4 years, and he was the man who caught that touchdown pass in the upset of Nebraska a couple of years ago. Had a tryout with the Cleveland Browns, who apparently wanted him to bulk up and play tight end. That hasn't happened yet. The end of the third quarter with Syracuse leading Johns Hopkins 14-11. We'll be right back. And part of the big crowd here in the Carrier Dome as you watch it live on Home Team Sports. Hope you're enjoying it. The opening game of the season, the 105th year of lacrosse for Johns Hopkins. They were beaten in their opening game a year ago at Homewood Field by Syracuse. The Orangemen in that game raced to a 9-1 lead. Here are the statistics in the game now through three quarters, and Syracuse pouring it on with the shots.
Yes, they have been. Man up goals. Hopkins has made pretty good use of their man-up opportunities. Right now they just held the ball, their man-up now, but they held the ball to not have to face off. Obviously they didn't want to face off. They want to take the time and set up their man-up.
Jeff Lyme has come on again. Number 21, there he is. Way outside, got the crossbar
Pipe
and ricochets
City.
Right out to midfield, takes a wicked bounce, and Bedwini has it.
He's trying to get in the box. He does.
Bedwini racing into the box. Behind the cage, he's going to look to solo it in there, and he just missed. Jones getting up to Pietramala, and he's going to take it a long way himself.
You definitely have to be in condition to play this sport, especially if you're going to be a midfielder. Right now, Hopkins going to settle it down. They're going to give Wood the ball to handle, number 15. There he is, who's had a real good day for Hopkins. He's an excellent lacrosse player. That's are most of these Hopkins players. It's a real close game. But Hopkins would like to get a goal here and get back into the momentum.
Here's Wilkins working hard.
Boy, he's got a hard shot. He's a big kid.
Fake shot wide. Hopkins keeps it.
Wilkins, who's had a man-up goal, is a big kid, 6'2", 185.
You want to talk big, Jim McNamara has just come on. He goes 210. 6 foot sophomore out of West Genesee High School.
Nice Bubier.
Didn't get the shot away, however. And O'Donnell gets it back to Gyrie, and he holds on in the crease.
No, in and out.
Yes, you're correct, Dale. He went out, came back in.
That happens. You know what he did? He had the 1 foot in. He had his left foot in, And when he reached out to get the ball, he just so slightly picked up the left foot, but he was out of the cage, and then as soon as he put it out of the crease, when he put it back down, that's it.
Yep, left foot.
There, see,
and
there,
the right foot came out, too.
He really did come out.
And here's Bubier, feeds the crease.
Bubier going to run it down and keeps this. Oh, that was deflected by O'Donnell. Stays a shot, Hopkins ball.
Bubier had a big third quarter. He scored three times. Ryan Wood scored three times in the first half. He was blanked in quarter number three. Mike Morrill, junior out of St. Paul's. Syracuse led at the quarter 5-3. At the half, 10-7, 14-11 after three. And that's where we are right now with 13 minutes exactly to play.
Hopkins kind of overloaded there, kind of
Brendan
an isolation.
Kelly got free, but he lost the ball. Bubier runs it down.
Scaramuzzino really hustling. 19 for Syracuse. Gets it ahead.
Steve Scaramuzzino. It's over his head, and who's got it? Nobody. And bouncing into the penalty box, Hopkins will take it.
Well, they were looking for the fast break. Burt streaked across the midfield, but the pass was high. And once again, Hopkins will get an opportunity. They really kind of overloaded. I thought they were just going to isolate on Scaramuzzino, but he was able to knock the ball down. Got it way downfield, but the bad pass gives Hopkins the ball back at their own midfield, and they're going to take it back to Jones.
And up the far sideline they go, Pietramala. For defenseman, he really controls the ball an awful lot.
He's been a real factor in this game. He's one of those sophomore defensemen. He's doing an excellent job for Hopkins.
Mike Morrill. Drawing O'Donnell.
This is a matchup we have seen before. O'Donnell trying to push him out.
Bubier, as the crowd applauds the Syracuse defensive effort. On the exchange to Ledoyen. Bouvier's left. Iam is right. He's got it now. Played by McNamara. Iam held in check and separated from the ball. Russell dribbles it a time or two.
This is a time when you can get.
And McNamara for Syracuse. Crowd comes to its feet. McNamara cranks and it's saved by Jones. He's out of the cage. He's got the ball. And he sends it to John Dressel, number two.
Goes back the other way. Fast break for Hopkins.
Ledoyen on the far side. Quickly down to Iam. He's coming in point blank. And he pays the price.
That wasn't even close. But that was one of those, I can't let him get a free shot on goal jobs. And they're going to get a 30-second penalty on a push. There it is, because they beat him on the wing. They beat him on the left side. There he is. And Guyrie saying, oh, give me some help. And then he gets it as they mug him before he gets his shot off.
Sophomore attack man out of Farmingdale, New York, on Long Island.
30-second penalty on
Mike O'Donnell is checked out.
Mike O'Donnell pushing.
O'Donnell is a senior from Yorktown.
10th man up opportunity for Hopkins.
Now here's Iam. Back to Brian Wood. He's in a quiet second half. Ledoyen. Pietramala, easy to spot with his gray undershirt hanging out.
They had Wilkins on the other side. Now they're going to bring, I don't know if he's going to come out or come over to the other side. He has blistering left-hand shot. Now Wilkins is back where we thought he would be. There's Bubier on the crease.
Cross field intended for Ledoyen. Still Hopkins controlling. And an errant pass over Wilkins' head. Toward the sideline, kept in bounds with a spectacular effort by Wood. What a play Brian Wood made.
He really is a great athlete. He went up about 3 feet in the air, controlled the ball, got it in. Hopkins got another opportunity. They have really been able to keep a run at Syracuse, but you got to credit Syracuse's defense. They have kept the ball out of the hole.
That was just an amazing effort by Brian Wood, who has it now, number 15. Knocks his man down, still works for the shot, and they take it away from him.
Now back to Hopkins.
And we get a hold on Brian Wood after that defensive play. He held on to Steve Scaramuzzino.
Credit Scaramuzzino with a good play after Wood made a couple of great ones, but then Wood on the ground held him with a stick. You can't do that. We'll see if we can see it. There's the Wood up over it, dragged that stick, held it back down, and there he's holding on to the stick right there.
You can't get away with much in this sport, can you?
I tell you, the officials really do an excellent job. They're using three officials for the first time in regular season games as a course of action this year.
And here comes McNamara. He had a run right up the middle earlier.
Syracuse's defense has been playing much more cohesively and much better as a team the second half, Dave. And they really stopped a number of Hopkins runs in this end of the third and into this fourth quarter. Syracuse now.
Gordy Mapes running on the exchange with John Zilberti, who has not scored. He's assisted twice. Now he's looking for his shot.
He's going to get doubled.
Gives it up, however, and boy, that shot ricocheted outside.
Hopkins ball, I think. We'll see.
Pietramala went down.
Yeah, Hopkins ball. Good hustle by Webster to get over by the end. But, you know, it seems to me that Zilberti is more content to look to feed, Dave. And he's had a couple times where he might have taken a shot, but he feeds the ball off. He fed that one off, not able to convert by Donahue. But it looks to me like Zilberti more or less looking to, at least this first game, to dish out the assist.
Well, you wonder if these stories tomorrow will come out and say Zilberti was used as a decoy. And here's Brian Woods, bounce shot handled by Guyery.
Guyery, good footwork that time. He needs some help, though. They're really going to put the pressure on the Syracuse clear and Guyery. But if you can get a leg up, it gives you a running start. They are after now.
9 minutes to go in the game.
It's McNamara, I believe.
Up he goes to Curry, and Curry will bring it across. Both teams change on the fly. Brendan Kelly and Pat Donahue come on. Todd Curry has given it up. Behind the cage now, Zilberti. Outside he goes to Rhett Cavanaugh. Transfer from Army a couple of years ago. Working the two-man game.
A lot of motion. Now using the 2-2-2, and they're just sending people. They're not staying around. They're not staying still. There's a lot of motion in that offense, and Mapes is going to be back to back it up.
And Todd Curry twisted an ankle. It's his right ankle on that quick spinning shot. Curry, who was injured early last season, played most of the year with an injured hamstring, appears to be walking it off. Roy Simmons wants a trainer to attend to him. Todd Curry.
Tim Neal, one of the trainers for Syracuse, will get right on it. They don't have this one in the bag yet. They want to make sure they can get Curry back.
Peter Allen has come on to replace him, number 15. And he still has it.
Looking for a push.
Zilberti faking.
He's going to get doubled. There he gets rid of the ball. Yep. He's kind of... Ball now going to the midfield line. This should be interesting. Syracuse offside.
So Hopkins is going to get it. 7:50 to go, and now the clock becomes a big factor. Hopkins is down by three. And the attendance tonight, 11,198. And as we speculated, it is the largest lacrosse-only crowd. There's been one larger crowd to watch a lacrosse game. 12,061 back in 83 for a Hobart game that was preceded by the Syracuse spring football game. Syracuse will be home again this year for a spring football game in conjunction with a lacrosse game. LeDoyan having trouble controlling.
Nice job by Burt playing defensively. This Syracuse defense has been playing much better the second half.
And in close for the shot is Russell. Did it go in? Yes.
Yes. Number eight.
So Pat Russell ends a scoring drought for Johns Hopkins. And the Blue Jays are back within two.
Here it is. There's Russell's got the arm out. Just moves.
Hopkins
tried it over the head.
Eight,
and he just goes inside. Guyery on the offside.
Russell.
Not able to stop it. You'll see it again. Watch Russell. There's the over the head. Misses. Russell keeps his feet and nice ball placement. He puts it by Guyery for the 12th Johns Hopkins goal.
Unassisted goal. Hopkins had gone 14 minutes without a score. Durjo with a fine effort. Knocks it back into the Hopkins half of the field. It's played by Webster, and he sends it back now to Lilly.
Nobody was released on that, so nobody could come out to play that ball. Durjo did the best he could. He has controlled the draw, but Hopkins up with a faceoff, 14-12.
And the dangerous Brian Wood has it now with some room to spare. Gives it up. Lyme is on the attack.
Janinchuk out at the top, number 13, and he is working on number 22 for Syracuse. That's Bedwini.
Janinchuk still has it. He gets double. He gives it up. And Chris Burt has done yeoman duty in the vicinity, and that may go against Syracuse. It will. Mike O'Donnell taking down John Ciccaroni.
Well, they're going to hit. They got, I didn't know if that was two penalties or only one, but Syracuse is going to be down for 30 seconds. Not something at this point. 10 attempts, 4 goals, man up. That's not a real bad percentage, actually. 40%. And timeout for Hopkins.
So the clock stops, 6:43 to play, and Syracuse clings to their 2-goal lead over Johns Hopkins. Last year, it was an 11-10 final. Well, they're enjoying themselves on this Saturday night in Syracuse in the Carrier Dome.
They just announced the attendance. Syracuse man down. And Wilkins with that left, he directs it across.
Now the shot is wide, but Hopkins will keep it. Now we'll try to keep an eye on the clock as well as on the action. 6.5 minutes to go in this game. Hopkins needs 2 to tie.
I still think it's going to be a 1-goal game either way.
Morrill is number 3. He's got it now. Wilkins open on this far side. Quick stick by Bubier. And the Blue Jays will continue to keep it.
Syracuse still down. 2 seconds left, we think, in the penalty.
Tom Nelson in the box.
Even up.
Now he comes on. They release Bedwini. Intercepted by Scaramuzzino. But he outlets it, and he throws it away. Mapes with a good fake to take the ball at midfield.
That's an important save for Gordy Mapes. There's a flag down.
Is Hopkins offside?
And he ran out of the box. He didn't see the flag. That's happened twice. Could be a slash. So now Syracuse will be man up. That was an important save by Mapes. I think it took a little bit of the momentum. Hopkins had an opportunity, didn't get a chance to do it. So Wood is going to be out for the slash.
Don't forget, those of you watching on Home Team Sports, there's more lacrosse coming your way after this one. Indoor lacrosse, Washington and Philadelphia.
Now Syracuse wants to be very patient on this and not to waste this man-up opportunity. And they'd like to get it in.
Chris Rossi is on. Hopkins in a tightly bunched defense. This and Todd Curry decided not to try it. Left-handed shot by Greg Burns, and back there is Gordy Mapes.
Well, that's when you're man up, you can get a guy back there to back up. You want to take good shots. That was a good one, didn't go in.
There's Curry cranking, bounce shot.
Off of the stick of Jones, who has, ooh, you heard that.
That's why they do not allow people to sit in that area. Syracuse quickly gets it in, 5 minutes, 29 seconds. Rossi, Hopkins is really packed in.
Well, they're going to.
They'll give Syracuse shooting room.
Well, they'll give him a screen, and ooh, he hit him right there.
Pietramala took it right in the back. There's Curry. Now Burns.
They'd like to get him unsettled. They'd like to get him over-shifting and sneak somebody from behind.
They're not doing much shifting, however.
No, they're
Curry with
long
a hard
shots.
Shot. This one nearly made the upper deck.
This is the third shot on that series, and you can hear the report as it hits the deck.
Jeschke tried the sneaky move, and now Hopkins has it. They try to get upfield in a hurry to Webster. 4:55 to go. Syracuse nearly stole it on the sideline. They do.
Good hustle, number 21 for Syracuse. That's Chris Rossi. And a timeout.
Timeout. With 4:51 to play, Syracuse has taken timeout. It is Syracuse 14 and Hopkins 12. And we hope you're enjoying watching it wherever you are tonight. 4 minutes, 51 seconds to go. Syracuse trying to get the crowd pumped up.
Hopkins just getting Janinchuk in. He was on the sideline talking. Didn't realize that the game was back in.
Long way from being over. 4:45 to go. Syracuse leads by two. Rhett Cavanaugh. Outside. Here's one of the Gait brothers. He's big. And shot his shot low. Is saved. Taken out of there by Pietramala.
Everybody's even, by the way.
Syracuse trying to make him work for every pass at this juncture of the game.
You've got to at this point in the game.
Every redirect is a valuable weapon for the team in the lead. It eats up precious time. Shannon Chuck feeding to Wood, faking.
Dangerous.
Bounce shot, saved by Gary. Where is it? Somebody's in the crease.
Yes. It was the big guy, Craig Bubier, in the crease as he shakes hands with Jim Guyry. But Wood, dangerous man to have, and he gets a shot off. You know, the problem is what Guyry did is he really couldn't control the rebound, and so now he just covered up on Bubier to make sure that nobody else got another shot off.
Jim Guyry out of Annapolis, Maryland. Bubier, also from Maryland. Here's Dan Pratt taking his time, tiptoeing up the sideline.
Well, he's got that big stick, and they don't want him to handle the ball too much, get it taken away from
Gordy
him.
Gordy Mapes, time to run some of that clock down. 3:35 to go. Syracuse by two. Zilberti with a little pick and roll. Zilberti flipping it in traffic.
Fed to crease. There was about a million people there. He was looking for Donahue.
Nelson holds it. The Gait. That was Gary Gates shooting the gap. The race is on. Hopkins is going to win it. Dale with a two-goal lead now. Why even rush the shot? Why not hold on until somebody comes out to play?
Well, I don't think they want to go out of their tempo. You can't say all of a sudden we're going to slow it down because they could get two goals so quickly you'd want that time back. So I think they just want to play the regular offense and not just sit down and try to play defensive lacrosse. Ball on the ground.
Got away from Chanichuk. Bubier has it.
He saves
it
in.
Bounds, but it's on the floor. It's Scaramuzzino. Whistle stops play. We may have a slash. Don Zimmerman up and over for an explanation quickly as Shannon Chuck walks toward the Hopkins bench.
Caught him on his shoulder, according to the official, so that'll be a slash. And now there's going to be one on Zimmerman. Unsportsmanlike, that's not releasable.
So with 3:04 to go, Hopkins really in the hole now. They're down by two. They have the slash and then the bench penalty.
Yep. You may not enter into an argument with an official as to any decision he has made or in any way attempt to influence the decision of an official. That's what it says in the book.
That brought out the yellow laundry.
Yep.
3 minutes and 4 seconds left to play.
One, two, three, four. So they are down two men. The in-home will have to sit out on the bench penalty if they're going to straighten out who's in and who's out.
Johns Hopkins has actually outscored Syracuse in the second half 5-4.
I think, as I said before, I think Syracuse defensively played much better in the second half. They played more cohesively, and they had a lot more to do with keeping the ball and getting it back to the offense.
Now Curry and Rossi cranks and scores. Second goal of the game for Chris Rossi.
Rossi just two men down. Hopkins really not much they can do, and you can't slide over and give up the pass across. So Rossi just cranked it, put it in the cage, makes it 15-12.
Syracuse has gone nearly 17 minutes without a score. Rossi and Curry gets the assist. Todd Curry, four goals and two assists. And it'll really be a struggle now for Johns Hopkins.
They're also still man down because that unsportsmanlike is not releasable.
Ryan Wood is in the penalty box.
No matter what happens, that will have to be served. And Burt just took the ball away, but was detected doing a little bit of pushing. So he will give up the ball. I don't know if there was possession or not. If there is, Burt will take a seat.
Brian Wood has come on. He scored three goals all in the first half. Bubier had three goals in the third quarter. Each team has only one goal in this fourth quarter. Rossi for Syracuse and Russell for Johns Hopkins.
Penalties on number 33, Syracuse, Chris Bird pushing 30 seconds.
Syracuse did not, Syracuse wants a timeout. They did not, I don't think they had what they wanted out there. I do not know how much time is left in the unsportsmanlike.
Game will be over in another 2 minutes and 40 seconds. Remember to please stay
off. We shall see.
Timeout, 2:40 left to go. We'll be right back. And the fans of both schools applauding their favorites as we're down to the final 2:40 in this game. A crowd of better than 11,000. Watching two schools that could meet again come the final four. Brendan Kelly has it now for Johns Hopkins.
I was going to say Hopkins is still down a man.
And Kelly's shot will remain in possession of the Blue Jays. They were closest to it.
Syracuse also has a man in the box.
Bubier works on Pratt.
So they are even.
Bubier is Ciccarone behind the net. Here's Bubier using his big size and taking a tremendous shot, and the flags fly in both directions.
They're trying to sort out how much time is left in each penalty.
Look at that stick. Look how bent it is.
Yep, that'll have to leave. But now Syracuse will be down a man. Hopkins, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now they've got 9 in, so I guess they're still down a man. Syracuse will be down 2 men, actually 1 man.
Hopkins has it, Kelly feeding, and Ciccarone is buried as he tried to get the pass away. Run over down there by O'Donnell.
Two men just came in. Syracuse is still a man down.
Ledoyen to Brian Wood. On the exchange with Ledoyen, he's going to dump it off in close. Score! Morrill connects.
Lots of time left. 1:49. Faceoffs become very, very important.
Mike Morrill, his third goal of the game with a minute 49 remaining. Here it is one more time as Ledoyen found him. And a little jump shot.
Yep, that was a man up goal. And now everybody's even. Now the faceoffs, as I said, become very important. Of course, Hopkins, Gunning, not in there, hurt that hand, and we have not seen him since in the game. So Dergel, 44, it becomes very important. He's got some wing people to help him. There's Guyery, who would like to see that faceoff go west. That would be toward the goal of John Hopkins.
Remember, Johns Hopkins has played most of the second half without their faceoff man Gunning, and now it's going to be Chanichuk on the faceoff.
Ball down.
Taken away by Hopkins. They need two to tie. It's 15-13, a minute 44 to go. John Ciccarone has an open man, shot and the save by Guyery. Rebound is over the crease and over the cage, and it's going to be Hopkins' ball. Pratt and Ciccarone exchanging pleasantries.
I hope nobody thought this was going to be easy. Fans are up, pushing on the end line. 1:32 left, lots of time. Syracuse scored 3 goals in 33 seconds. Man
here,
open.
Here comes Ciccarone. Kelly is in close. They give him the middle. And he shoots, and it's deflected again. Two golden opportunities for Johns Hopkins. A minute 22 to go. And the ball's quickly put back in play. Here's Bubier. Bubier stopped. Bubier shot. Pratt takes it away. Bubier regains. Syracuse unsettled momentarily. Bubier taken away again. It's Burt. Morrow pursues him. Knocked out of his stick. Who's got it? Hopkins again.
103. What an exciting game. Timeout. Last one for Hopkins.
Timeout, Hopkins. 1 minute, 3 seconds remaining. Syracuse.
Well, so we've got 63 seconds to go, and it's a torrid pace here in the close of this game with Hopkins pouring it on. They're down by two, 15 to 13.
Well, they had the unsportsmanlike on the bench, and then Syracuse had some penalties. Nobody able to take advantage of that situation. And then they finally got back even, and now a rush at the Syracuse goal. They've had a couple of shots at Guyrie, had a couple of saves. As you said, a couple of perhaps opportunities missed. But this is going to go right down to the wire.
Also injured on the sideline, Steve Mitchell. He hasn't seen any action. There he is, number 44. The gloves are off. The coat's going on now. But in the huddle, Don Zimmerman with his final timeout.
Well, he's got to say there's lots of time left. And, of course, if we get the next goal, the faceoff becomes important. And the faceoffs have started to even up now. 14 for Hopkins, 16 for Syracuse. You can't get too much more even.
Next week, Johns Hopkins on the road again as they go to Rutgers. Their first home game will be Tuesday, March 17th. That'll be a 3 o'clock game at Homewood Field. Then they'll have home games against Princeton and Virginia, March 21st and 28th. On the road at North Carolina on April the 4th. Home against Army on the 11th. And home against Navy on April 25th. That'll be homecoming at Homewood. Left. Syracuse leads by two, 15-13.
Brian Wood's going to bring it in. And Burt's going to pick him up as Wood takes it way up on the wing.
Eating up valuable time, but here comes Wood.
One-on-one.
What a move he makes. Wood comes in, he scores. Beating Scaramuzzino in the Syracuse defense. And this is a one-goal game with 51 seconds left.
That's exactly what they wanted to do. You said he made a great move. He took the ball from behind, took it way up on the wing, and he beat Burt, 33, right there. And Burt tried to get on the stick too late, and the ball low by Guyrie. That makes it 15-14. 51 seconds left. Face-offs, you can make 100 of them, but this is the one that's important right now, and they've got Donahue, I believe, out there.
So this could be the game right now. 51 seconds to go. This crowd of 11,000 rising to their feet as Burt wins the face.
Syracuse controls.
Donahue has it. Looking to give it up, spotting an open man. It's Curry in the middle of the field. He's buried. And a whistle stops the play with 40 seconds to go.
Well, Pietramala did the only thing he could do. He had to try to stop it. The timing was just off a second. That's all it needed. It's going to give Syracuse the ball, but it did stop play. And they get them all set. Pietramala's.
It's in the stick of Kavanaugh. Here we go. Rossi. Hopkins needs the ball back. Rossi to Kavanaugh. They're going to try to play keep away now.
They're going to count 5 seconds. They have to take it within 5 yards. They're not going to even be warned for stalling.
Zoberti has it. Zoberti fakes and keeps. Zoberti finds Kavanaugh with 18 seconds to play.
All right, now they're telling him they have to keep it in.
Zoberti in the box, changing directions. Zoberti taken down, picked up by Hopkins. 6 seconds to go. I don't think they can get a shot away. Wood is running, redirecting it with 1 second. It's all over. The Syracuse team pouring onto the field to congratulate goalie Jim Guyrie. What a scene. Roy Simmons offering his congratulations. As Jim Guyrie is mobbed by his teammates after the 15-14 defeat of Johns Hopkins.
Well, I thought it was going to be a one-goal game either way, as Hopkins really rushed at him at the end, came up with that great goal, but they were not able to come up with it at the end. And the faceoff, the last faceoff, but Brian Wood really put the excitement back in it for the Hopkins fans. What a great athlete he is. What a great bunch of athletes both of these teams have. And as you said, Dave, very, very probable, or at least it's possible, they could meet as the national champion in the Final Four this year.
Each team is on a mission. We'll be right back. Dave Cohen along with Dale Drypolter. We're back live in the Carrier Dome in Syracuse. This one certainly lived up to its billing and then some, as Syracuse has defeated Johns Hopkins 15-14. Down below there's Jim Geary getting the congratulations of his head coach Roy Simmons, his assistant John Desco. And it is a big win for Syracuse as they defeat Johns Hopkins for the second year in a row in the opening game, 15-14. Last year it was 11-10 at Homewood Field. And again, this year Syracuse out to the early lead, although not nearly as big as a year ago.
Yeah, there was a lot of different games in here. It went back and forth. The action came in spurts, and it was, I think it was an exciting game. Hopkins fans, I think, saw a good game. Nobody's out of anything. It's just, I think you said it at the beginning of the show, these teams could very well be number one and two in the country when the season ends. But I think it was a good game, and I think it gives each team a lot to look at as the season goes on.
From Hopkins' standpoint, you have to be concerned with the injuries to Gunning, the faceoff man who was hurt. Also, late in the game, Mitchell went out with an apparent injury, did not play down the stretch. So you wonder just how they're doing. Gunning looked to be the more seriously hurt with either a wrist or a shoulder injury.
Absolutely, and that could have hurt them, and we say it may hurt them as the season goes on. Syracuse certainly benefited, but they got that last faceoff, which was probably the most crucial one of the game, and were able to run out the clock, but it was an exciting game, and as I think you said, Dave, these are great athletes on both teams.
Let's take a look now at some of the final statistics in this game, and you can see Syracuse enjoy the shot advantage.
The shots, really, Syracuse got off 12 more shots. Ground balls, Syracuse 47-32. Man-up goals, I thought that Hopkins really did a pretty good job of that. Syracuse ended up 3-for-7. Face-offs got much closer as the game went on. Syracuse dominated for 3-4 times in a row, and Hopkins came back. Clears very even. I think you have two very even teams. The shots, I think that Jones really was tough in the goal. A little shaky early. Really got strong as the game went on. Then he had that flurry against him, 3 goals in 33 seconds. But I think he's a real good goalie, and nobody else saw any action for him, so I think they're satisfied with him.
Ryan Wood had 3 goals in the first half. Then he was kind of quiet in that third quarter. He did suffer an injury, too, an ankle that he turned, but he came back and he played well. And here's the final goal of the game for Johns Hopkins, Wood.
He went way out up on the wing, and there was the move. And he just did a job on Burt, and then he takes the shot. Burt tried to get him to hold the stick back, but this man is really the epitome of Johns Hopkins lacrosse. He did a great job, and he came up with it when they needed it. They could have come back and perhaps tied the game, but it was not to be, but he did a super job. And I think both teams played very well. Both coaches, I'm sure, are going to be satisfied. I don't think Coach Zimmerman's going to be satisfied with a loss, but if your team can lose and play well, they did.
Down at the other end, John Zilberti, who did not score a goal in the game but had 2 assists, did a fine job of playing keep away in the closing seconds as Syracuse managed to keep the ball long enough so that when Hopkins finally got it with about 6 seconds left, they were at the other end of the field and just could not get anything close to a shot away. So let's take a look now at the final seconds of this game and the reaction on the part of the Syracuse team as they know they finally have it.
Now, Syracuse eventually got the faceoff, as we said. Then that's the last shot after they got the ball back. Hopkins got the ball back, but you can see Syracuse as they're waiting for that clock to run out, and there's the last shot. As they get the ball to Jones, and he took the last shot for Hopkins.
Todd Curry with the stick raised. He led Syracuse in scoring in this game with 4 goals and 2 assists. 3 goals by Gordy Mapes, 2 by Chris Rossi. And oddly enough, Tom Nelson did not have a point in the game, according to my scorecard. John Zilberti, the freshman a year ago who was so outstanding, setting Syracuse records for goals and assists. No goals and 2 assists in this game. For Johns Hopkins, Mike Morrill had 3 goals, and we told you Brian Wood had 4. 1 apiece in this game for Bruce Chaninchuk, Pat Russell, John Wilkins, and Pietramala also had 1 goal. So the final score in this contest is Syracuse 15 and Johns Hopkins 14. Hope you enjoyed it tonight from the Carrier Dome in Syracuse. Tonight's game has been produced and directed by Gary Mariano, our coordinating producer, Bob Jubinville, and a remote supervisor, Andy Swite. Now, speaking for Dale Drypulcher, this is Dave Cohen thanking you for joining us and reminding you to be with us for Syracuse Lacrosse throughout the 1987 season. Check the time and place in your area. This has been a presentation of Macaw Cablevision of Syracuse.